get prepared for what type of football game we're about to get ready to play against Parkview.
For those that aren't familiar with Parkview, what style of offense and defense do they run, how we are going to prep?
They are a true, you know, pro-style offense. They use a tight end. They use what people call these days as a sniffer. So it's some 21 personnel, and they're going to run power. They're going to run counter, you know, and they're going to play action and throw some boot stuff off of it. Defensively, man, they have athletes everywhere. They got guys that can make a lot of plays, and they're gonna do a good job of getting prepared for what we do. And you know, if we can do the same thing, and we can give ourselves a chance.
What's the one thing you want to see defensively against an athletic team like that? If we need to come out with a win,
we have to tackle well. Without a doubt, they got two kids in the backfield that are highly talented kids, big kids, very powerful and athletic kids that can run. So we're going to have to do a good job of tackling and game tackling at that. They're pretty big kids. So, you know, one guy's not going to take them down. So we're going to have to get to the ball on the defensive side of the ball, game tackle, and try to create some turnovers.
War Memorial, the second biggest stadium in the state of Arkansas. How do you keep the players, just remind them that this is just a normal game outside of the larger venue?
Well, it don't matter about the venue. You know, you still got to get on those white lines. In between those white lines, you still got to snap the ball. You still got to block. You still got to catch balls. You still have to tackle. So it don't matter where you are at any point. We try not to, you know, let that get to our heads, and it's football. We're playing football. No matter where we're playing, we can go in the backyard if it's lined up, and you still have to go out and execute the things that you've been coached to do throughout the week.
Two straight weeks I've had the privilege to ask this. Didn't seem like there was an empty seat at Patriot Stadium. What'd you think of the crowd?
Man, it's awesome, you know, and that says a lot about, you know.
From high atop War Memorial Stadium, Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye, here to bring you Marion Patriot action against the Little Rock Parkview Patriots. Should be a fun one, Ronnie.
Sounds good to me. I've been looking forward to this all week. Patriots versus Patriots. You can't go wrong with that.
Last year, Patriots winners 2019, just a year ago, 1 point the difference between these two teams. One big piece of news for it, Kentrell Jones last year, 3 rushing touchdowns for Marion. This year, sorry, Kentrell, you're my guy and everything, but we're going to have to rely on somebody else. News came out, torn ACL and meniscus, so no Kentrell for probably the remainder of the season. But that gives a chance for some other players to step up.
Exactly. That's what you have to see. In that case, you have to have the next man come up and take care of business, and that's what we look for tonight.
Talking with Coach Heath Houston before the game, it looks like some of the names to look for are going to be sophomore Brandon Hayes, junior Antonio Grays. These are some players that are going to be coming over from the defensive side of the ball. One problem that they had with players like Hayes, he was an offensive player in junior high, but he's athletic enough, they tried to find a place for him. The running back spots were filled with seniors, so they got him an opportunity on defense. Now he's going back to his original position at running back. Should be interesting.
It's a good problem to have. when you got people you can move around like that and have athletes, they can execute. Should be fine.
One other thing with this game, a venue like this, it's not going to be to capacity at all. They're only putting seats on the visitor side. But still, this is a historic venue. It's extremely large. Main thing, you can't get lost in the moment.
That's right. And we have the best seats in the house, Tyler.
No doubt. So, Ronnie, your keys to the game. This is a very big, athletic Parkview team. What do you want to see from Marion?
Well, defensively, we've got to stop McCauley. He's the workhorse for them, offensively and defensively. He had 101 tackles last season for this Parkview team, so he's going to be a big part of this team. And their quarterback, of course, Landon Rogers, have to keep an eye on him as well.
What do you want to see the Patriots do offensively? This is a big Parkview defense.
I think it should be a breakout game for a quarterback. I look forward to Kale coming through and having a big game for us.
Also of note to look forward to in this game, pretty good-sized Marion following. I wasn't expecting this. You look over across the way, I'm seeing a ton of people. What are your thoughts on the travel so far?
I've been real impressed with Marion School District and all the support that goes on with that, and this is just an indication of that. We see a large band here. You see people traveling. I know they had, I don't know how many buses that took off today carrying people, so you can't. I mean, it's just a great atmosphere at Marion School District.
In other Patriot news, I heard you got to watch some of the volleyball game yesterday. 5-set win over Paragould yesterday. Pretty impressive showing. Main player that we were talking about over the broadcast yesterday, Kirsten Jackson, incredible game. Got some tips, got some really good saves. Also got to talk to Deidreana Kale before this game. She's one of the managers for the team. Pretty exciting win for the Lady Patriots, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, and it was a great broadcast. You guys did a great job. That's my first time to see that. And it was an awesome broadcast yesterday. Got to see the whole thing. So it was pretty good.
Also, for those that may not know, if you didn't catch the PatCast yesterday, Ronnie Dye is actually our head tennis coach for the boys. Just give us a little bit of an update on y'all's season so far.
Yeah, it's been we're 2-3-2 right now on the boys' side. We're 2-4-1 on the girls' side. It's a process, and we're growing and we're getting better, and we're looking forward to district here in just a few weeks. So.
I know your motto for the tennis team, level up. Can you explain that a little bit?
Yeah, level up. Basically, what I'm asking them to do is whatever they're used to is to raise it up a notch. And so whatever we did this week, we expect them to do a little more next week. And by the end of the season, we're looking for big things. So.
Should be a fun broadcast. I'm ready for action between the Patriots and the Patriots. Anything you want to add
before
we wrap up the pregame?
It's going to be fun. Yes, sir.
All righty, so that'll wrap up the pregame. Kickoff will be starting at 7 o'clock here at MarionPatriots.com. Be sure to share the link. Share it on all the social media that you have. Should be a fun one here for War Memorial as we get ready to kick things off. So for our ever-growing crew and a ton of cameras that we have here, ton of lighting equipment and everything, I'm excited to get this rolling. I'm ready to get our 2019 football broadcast season rolling.
Let's do it.
So for Ronnie, this is Tyler. For Landon, McGuire, Chandler, and all the way down there, Miss Mary Reese, I'm Tyler Bennett saying come join us in a minute. Go Pats.
AMS Realty is a privately owned real estate company specializing in property management. They currently manage over 300 rental units in Crittenden County. If your rental property has become a burden, give them a call and let them tell you how they can relieve the burden. They have no upfront fees, and their monthly management fee is based solely on rents collected. If they don't collect the rent, they don't get paid. Give AMS Realty a call at 739-3000.
Hello, I'm Pastor James Nicholson of First Marion. We're under construction in our sanctuary building. We're excited about the changes that are on the horizon, but more than that, we want to help you construct your life in a way that honors God and brings blessings to you. We want to invite you to join us on November the 3rd at 10 o'clock as we dedicate our service to the ministries of Marion. Come and join us at First Marion, the church in the curve.
Wouldn't it be great if there was a one-stop shop for all of your automotive, hardware, lawn and garden, and farm supply needs? It just so happens that such a place exists right here in Marion. Cliff's Auto Parts. Family-owned for 32 years, they can cut keys of all kinds, including transponder keys. They also create custom hydraulic hoses, and they carry a wide range of lawnmower parts. If they don't have it, they can get it. Cliff's Auto Parts. 120 Block Street in Marion.
At Faulkner Eye Clinic, they strive to treat you the way that you want to be treated, with top quality eye care by use of technology and experience. Quality to them means being thorough and finding out how you use your vision, thus helping your efficiency. The long-term health of your eyes and vision need to be protected. That's why pictures of your retina and scans of your eyes can be important parts of protecting your vision from health issues like diabetes and high blood pressure, or vision issues like cataracts, macular degeneration, or glaucoma. Faulkner Eye Clinic. They want to help you help yourself. A proud Patriot partner.
When you want hometown health care, you want
the ball lead by a score of 6-0.
Jones looking, steps, throw. the legend's rising. We burn it out, a mile wide. When ashes fall, the legend's rising.
And welcome to War Memorial Stadium, just south of Markham Street here in downtown Little Rock. Exciting one between the Patriots and the Patriots. Marion versus Parkview. Right now, the captains are out at center field for the Patriots. It's Daedric Kale, Ken Brown, Kentrell Jones, and Slade Webb. It appears that Parkview has won the toss. So now they're talking to Marion. I believe they were going to defer the toss. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye, head tennis coach for the Marion Patriots. We have the result of the coin toss. Marion has won the toss and elects to defer. So Parkview will be getting the ball first. We'll get to see that giant quarterback, Mr. Landon Rogers. He is a junior, but so is Marion's quarterback. Last year, Daedric Kale, Arkansas Democrat Gazette Player of the Year for a sophomore in the state of Arkansas, both in football and baseball. But Landon Rogers, a tall drink of water, as they say, Ronnie.
I read, I was telling you this earlier before the broadcast, that he has 11-inch hands.
Man.
I can't imagine shaking hands with that guy, you know?
Both teams are Patriots, but you'll be able to tell the two teams apart. Marion in a very classy look, I have to say, with the navy helmets, white jerseys, and navy pants. Parkview with white helmets and baby blue jerseys and pants. Just behind us at the War Memorial Press Box is the War Memorial Golf Course. To our right is the Little Rock Zoo as the Parkview Patriots take the field. Directly in front of us is UAMS, and to our left is historic Markham Street. The Marion Band is in the south end zone. That would be to our right. And now the Patriots through their tunnel, being led by, I believe that's Coach Fulmer. Should be an exciting one. Main thing for Marion has been the injury report. Couple injured players such as Slade Webb with a broken collarbone. He had surgery on it and is going to find out some more information about a possible return for him. One player we can count out for a return, unfortunately, Kentrell Jones. Torn ACL and meniscus in the 0-week game against Blyville.
Hated to hear that news. I didn't realize that until you mentioned it just right before we started.
I happened to go downfield level just before kickoff and talk with Coach Houston. He didn't. Obviously, you hate to lose a player as talented as that, but you can't afford to dwell on it. Main thing he was saying, you just have to reload and keep firing. One thing of note, the end zones pregame walking around on the field, almost like a hill in the end zone. Elevated the closer you get to the seats in both end zones. So last year as a freshman, Dylan Pieri got the kicking duties for the Patriots. Now as a sophomore, he may be even better.
Looks like back deep for Parkview, number nine, DJ or Demetrius Feimster, and number one, James Joyner.
Feimster on the near side, Jointer on the far side of the field. Patriots last week against Wynn started the game off with an onside kick. Be interesting to see if they go for that again. Parkview lining up six around the 50-yard line with five back beyond them. So Pierre and his unit are set. Parkview is set. And we are underway for Moore Memorial. This one will go to Feimster. He'll take it at about the 7. Feimster rolling back to the middle of the field, runs into his own player and is tackled by a Patriot defender just shy of the 25-yard line. They'll mark him at the 24, first and 10 for Parkview.
Looked like 19, Thomas Doran on that tackle.
Doran, a wide receiver, but if they're talented enough, you'll put them anywhere. Starting running back for Parkview, James Jointer. Two wide receivers on either side of the field for Rogers. The handoff goes to Jointer. He's met immediately at the line. Short gain. Gain of maybe 3.
Nice play there on the end. It's hard to see those numbers tonight.
That's silver on white. I believe that's Drew Granger with the tackle, the near side end.
It's a nice play by him there to shorten that run for Joyner.
So for the Patriots, that front line for Marion, Jaqueline Daniel, Justin Scott in the middle. And on the near side, the handoff is a fake to Jointer, and they throw to the far side. He's going to be tackled by number 4. That's Brandon Hayes. Pass is complete to Marcus Hill. He'll be just short of the line to gain. Line to gain being the 34-yard line. They're going to mark him at the 32. So 3rd and 2 for Parkview. Parkview in an I formation now. Jointer's the tailback. They hand it off to the fullback. He's going to get past the 34. They're going to mark him just shy of the 36. Thomas McCauley, I believe, is who they give that to. That'd be number 2 is the fullback. They needed 2 yards. They got 4. Under center is Rogers, trying to draw Marion offside. 3 wide receivers on the far side of the field. Jointer is the halfback behind Rogers. 1 wide receiver on the near side for Parkview. Rogers tosses it to Jointer. He runs to the far side of the field. He gets to the 40. Gets past midfield, almost pushed out of bounds. They are going to say he went out of bounds. Knocking him out of bounds is number 45, Rizel Rux.
Rux was able to push him out of bounds there, get him out, or else that was going to be 6, I'm afraid.
One thing you have to worry about with Parkview is those big blockers, but especially on a toss play like that, you get your wide receivers involved in the blocking. That could be huge the rest of the way.
And Jointer with 4-5 speed can go.
2 wide receivers near side. They try a jet sweep. It's dropped by number 9 initially. He runs into his own man. He's going to be dropped just short of the 40, making the tackle for the Patriots, D'Antonio Moore. Jet sweep to Demetrius Feimster. Almost dropped it, but still able to get 5 yards out of it.
It looked like they had it set up there, but that drop on the exchange kind of made it possible for Marion to catch up and make a play there.
We have a whistle. 3 Patriot coaches are almost to the numbers. A little bit of a confusion here. It's 2nd down and 5 right now. Ball is at the 41-yard line. Line to gain is the Marion 36. Now they're going to take it back. So they're going to put the ball back at the 46-yard line, and it's still going to be 2nd down. Oh, because it's a jet sweep, that's an incomplete pass.
Pass, yeah.
So 2 wide receivers either side for Parkview. Jointer, the running back next to Rogers. Rogers looks to the far side of the field. He's going to throw to the far side. Just throws it behind the intended receiver. I believe that's McCauley.
It looked like it might have been touched there by Rux on that far side.
Yeah, he throws it behind the intended receiver. That's Feimster. So it'll be 3rd and 10 for Parkview. Ball is at the Marion 46-yard line. Line to gain is the 36. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Rogers. Jointer remains the running back. Somebody jumped.
Yeah, we had movement here on this right side, number 65, looked like.
Yeah, it looked like the near side of the line, and maybe the running back jumped before the snap. So that'll cost Parkview five more yards. That'll put them back inside Parkview territory. Third and 15, 9:42 remaining in our opening quarter here from Markham Street War Memorial Stadium.
I like them, Tyler, being on this side of the field on this fourth hash over here. You know, there's four hashes on on the field out there.
Three wide receivers far side of the field for Rogers. Rogers looking to the far side of the field. He's having to roll. Great pressure by Justin Scott. Throw is it's batted out and caught by Parkview. This is going to be a touchdown for Feimster. Look what I found. Wow. Patriots couldn't have played that one any better, but they tipped it right to Feimster, and he takes it to the house.
Wow.
Sometimes you'd rather be lucky than good.
I tell you, and that's exactly what that was.
App Rogers throwing it. It gets batted by D'Antonio Moore, and Feimster takes it to the house. So out to kick the extra point that appears to be Giovanni Riovilta. Extra point is good, and Parkview leads 7-0. 9:32 remaining in our opening quarter. Parkview leads 7-0. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
When you want hometown health care, you want Marion Minor Medical, a proud Patriot partner.
Seven nothing Parkview, our score here from War Memorial Stadium. Parkview scoring on a 51-yard touchdown pass. Tipped in the air by D'Antonio Moore. Caught by Feimster of Parkview and taken to the house. Just a look what I found kind of play.
Yeah, he caught the ball probably around the 10-yard line and couldn't have been any better for Parkview.
So back to receive for the Patriots. Antonio Graves is on the near side. On the far side, that's number 86, that's Gabe Millen. They're kicking it to Millen's side. Millen will take it in front of the 25-yard line. He runs backwards. He'll be tackled at around the 26. They're going to mark him at the 25. So 7-0 Parkview as the Patriot offense gets ready to take the field. With the injuries, it's going to be interesting to see who's going to step up for the Patriots. Reload and keep on firing. That's been the motto for the Patriots so far with these injuries.
The stadium has such a nice history. It's pretty neat to be here, and these kids get to experience playing on this field.
Oh, absolutely. Anthony Price is the starting running back. Three wide receivers on the near side for Daedric Cale. One wide receiver to the far side of the field. Cale, the handoff goes to Price. Price able to break the 25-yard line, gets close to the 30, ends into the linebackers. They're going to mark him down at the 29-yard line. Line to gain is the Marion 35.
That was number 75, Kendall McKenzie, in on the stop. Sophomore lineman.
Patriots showing the same formation. Three wide receivers near side of the field. They hand it off again to Price. Price again gets past the initial line of defense, gets past the 30. They're going to mark him at the 32-yard line. This will be third down and about three for Marion.
51, Jared Summons in on that. He's the nose guard for this Parkview defense. Big 6'4", 320-pound junior.
Two receivers either side of the field for Marion. Third down and three. Need to get past the 35 to extend the drive. K. Cale fakes the handoff to Price. Now rolling to the far side of the field. He's going to keep it himself. Able to get all the way to the line to gain. It's going to depend on the spot, but I believe that's a first down. So they're going to mark it just shy of the 35. That'll be fourth and short, fourth and inches.
Patriot. I thought he had made it past the 35 there, but I guess they marked his knees down there.
Three receivers near side of the field, fourth and inches for Marion. Could be trying to draw Parkview offside. Now they change the formation. Price goes behind Cale. Price was leaning forward, and I believe they're going to get him for the false start. So 5 yards will send the punting unit out for Marion. Three and out on their first drive, 7:36 remaining in the opening quarter.
Price was a little too anxious to get that first down right there. Just kind of leaned on him a little bit.
This will send the senior punter, Jace Boney, out. Back to receive for Parkview is Feimster. Boney's punt is a low one. It'll drop just shy of midfield. It takes a Patriot roll inside the 35 at the 30, dropping, and the Patriots will down it just shy of the 27-yard line. So Parkview will take over in between the 27 and the 28. We'll call it the 28. 7:25 remaining opening quarter. Difference in this one so far, a lucky bounce for Parkview.
It's a nice bounce there on that punt for Marion.
Parkview has some size. They open up with a sniffer back look just in front of the running back. Jointer. Rogers will hand off. They fake it. Rogers keeps it himself. He gets to the 35-yard line. He'll be tackled at around the 36. Rogers not afraid to keep it himself. Gain of about 8. It's 2nd and 2.
Rogers, a 6'5", 220-pound junior. Pretty big quarterback. Nice size.
Again, these two teams met last year. A one-point win for Marion, 20-19. All three touchdowns for Marion coming from Kentrell Jones. Same look with the sniffer back. They move him to the far side now. The running back for Parkview is Khalib Pree. Handoff almost intercepted. The far side corner, that's number 35, Dorian Giles. Or correction, they're going to give it to Brandon Hayes. Brandon Hayes almost coming up with the interception.
Nice anticipation there by Hayes on that play.
Got to say, Rogers' throws so far have not been on point.
It kind of looked like he threw that one a little sidearm too.
So 3rd and 2 for Parkview. They're showing that sniffer back look again. Now we have a whistle on the far side, and Parkview will burn their first timeout.
It's probably a good thing they called that timeout as well. Antonio Gray's blew past that tackle. He's about to get in on the quarterback.
6:36 remaining in the opening quarter. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Finner Physical Therapy has been serving Crittenden County since opening in Marion in 2007. 11 years later, you can find them throughout eastern Arkansas. Their treatment options include physical, occupational, and speech therapy services at all 5 of their locations. Other therapy services include sports injury rehab and prevention. Finner Physical Therapy further boasts the only aquatic therapy pool in the region at their West Memphis Delta Orthopedics and Sports Medicine location. Does your student athlete have a recent injury that needs rehab or even a past injury that needs strengthening?
Finner Physical Therapy got me back on the court stronger than ever.
Call the Finner Physical Therapy team to find out more about how we work to strengthen.
I formation for Parkview. Rogers hands it off to the halfback. He's going to be met at the 35. He's going to go backwards. That's going to be a loss of a yard for Parkview. Great defense by the Marion Patriots.
Number 12, Jaqueline Daniel in on that play.
So Parkview's going to have to punt. Punter for Parkview is number 87. Not on roster, so we'll just see how it goes. Thomas Doran is the near side back to return. On the far side is Antonio Grays. They'll kick it towards Antonio. It'll bounce just shy of the 30. Take a Parkview roll inside the 20. Around the 15, it keeps on rolling. Just shy of the 10, it'll be at about the 11 or 12 yard line. Patriot volleyball 4-0 in conference play so far, and they'll be back at home all this week. Tuesday night, they'll be at home against the Jonesboro Golden Hurricane. Then Thursday, come see us at the arena. That's right, Patriot Arena for Patriots and Blue Devils. Should be a fun one in Patriot volleyball. Again, 4-0, a huge five-set win yesterday at Paragould.
It's been a while since they've won at Paragould, is that correct?
Yeah, last night was the first time they've taken a set at Paragould since 2016.
Nice.
Two wide receivers either side of the field for the Patriots. Anthony Price is the running back next to Kale. They fake the handoff to Kale. The pass is complete. That's Caden Hunt. Caden gets past the 20. It'll be a fresh set of downs for the Patriots. He goes all the way past the 25. Great way to keep those legs moving.
Nice job by Hunt on that. At the end of that play, he got another couple yards just by, like you said, keeping his legs moving and driving forward.
Caden will go to the far side now. Two wide receivers either side. Anthony Price remains the running back with Kale. Kale motions Price. He's going to look towards his way. Now Kale's going to keep it himself. Able to get past the linebackers. He's going to slide past the 30. Pretty sizable gain by Daedrick.
That was a nice read there by Kale on that play. He had a wide hole there to take that ball and get about
Markham just
yards.
Shy of the 33-yard line. This will be second down and about three for the Patriots. Three wide receivers on the far side for Kale. They fake the handoff to Price. He's going to throw again to Hunt. Hunt past the 40. Hunt past midfield. Breaks a tackle. Hunt to the 45. Great run by Caden Hunt.
Nice job by Hunt. Nice route that he ran, and Kale put the ball right on the money. And great execution there by the Marion offense.
Last week he was torn up about the loss to Win. I expect a bounce back game for Caden Hunt. Three wide receivers far side of the field. Daedrick looking down the middle. He's going to throw to the running back. It's Price. Price hit immediately short of the line of scrimmage. Parkview there to sniff that one out.
Didn't hold the block long enough here on this side, and that Parkview defense was able to read that pretty good.
Original line of scrimmage was the Parkview 43-yard line. They're marking him at the 46, loss of 3 on the play. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Price remains the running back. Kale looking to the near side of the field. He's got a man open. It's Doran. Doran drops it. Great defense by Parkview. It looked like the corner was able to get a hand on it and knocks the ball free of Doran.
That was a good look. Great call there. And just had it in his hands. And like you said, the defensive guy probably had a hand on that ball.
Empty set for the Patriots. Three wide receivers far side of the field, two on the near. Third and 13. Daedrick looking far side, now looking near. Throwing back to Doran. Doran just past the outstretched arms. Patriots probably going to have to punt.
I'm not sure. Is that a flag right there by the 40-yard line, or is that just some tape or something? You
see
that?
That's some tape. So the Patriots will send the punt team out.
That play, they ran it again, and it's a little long that time.
So they like the look there they have with Doran, apparently. 4:10 remaining first quarter. Boney the punter. I believe that's Feimster back to receive for Parkview. Again, a beauty of a punt by Boney. This one's going to bounce just short of the 20. Take a Marion roll to about the 15. It goes out of bounds at around the 16-yard line. 4 minutes even remaining opening quarter. So the Patriot defense, pretty solid job so far. The difference, again, just a lucky bounce. Haven't been too impressed with the throws by Rogers for Parkview, but He's got a touchdown throw off of a lucky bounce.
I think they've been more of a rushing team. I think they're trying to pass the ball more this season, from what I've heard and read. So far, they've not executed well on that.
McCauley is the running back. They'll hand it off to him. He's met immediately at the line of scrimmage. Justin Scott with the big tackle.
Nice play there by the interior for Marion as they were able to stop McCauley, which is a tough task.
Line of scrimmage was the 16-yard line. They're marking him down at the 14, loss of two.
McCauley, the team captain for Parkview. He's 6'1", 225, a senior.
So a loss of three on the run. Great play by Justin Scott. He was all over the field last week against Wynn.
McCauley had 855 yards last season on the ground.
Jointer will come back in at running back. Rogers looking to throw. Rogers plenty of time. He's going to throw to the near side. It's almost picked again. Great play. I believe Brandon Calvert got a hand on it.
Brandon Calvert probably wishes he could have that one again because he might have had a pick six had he come up with that.
Patriots have had several hands on the balls. They're going to get an interception if this keeps up.
Great job by that defense.
So third and long for Parkview, third and about 13. 3:13 remaining in our opening quarter. Jointer is the running back with Rogers. Three wide receivers far side of the field for Rogers. High snap. Rogers is pressured. Now he's going to have to throw down the middle. Bad throw. Intended receiver was Aaron Outley, but it's incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth and long.
Again, nice job by the Marion defense.
First one I saw was Jaquelin Daniel causing some pressure, causing him to roll.
He and Justin Scott were both back there and forcing the Rogers to get rid of it.
So 87, the punter, Doran, back to receive at the Parkview 40. Low snap. Patriots almost getting a hand on it. Doran touched it.
No.
And that'll be Parkview ball.
Just a bad read there on the by the receiver on that. That's two snaps in a row that have bounced to the punter, and we might be able to get one of those before this night's over.
So big swinging momentum there. Patriots able to cause fourth and long, almost getting the block. But Parkview gets the ball. I believe they're marking it at the 28-yard line. 3 minutes to go in our opening quarter. I formation for the Patriots. Handoff is again to the fullback. That's McCauley. McCauley met immediately at the line of scrimmage. No gain.
Nice job. Number 54 in on that play.
Pretty reminiscent of a season ago. Last year, Patriots slow starts in their first three games. We're seeing that again. Parkview will show an I formation again. This is a weak I, as the fullback is now off to the left side. Rogers is going to throw to the far side. Man is wide open at midfield. He gets pushed out of bounds by Brandon Hayes. Big play for Parkview.
DJ Feimster again open on that far side. Was able to pick up the first down.
And he was wide open around midfield. So first and 10 for Parkview on the Marion side of the field at the 45.
Feimster's another one of the seniors for this Parkview team. He was all conference last season, 4.3 speed.
I formation again for Parkview. They hand it off to the halfback. It's Jointer. Jointer able to get around the near side. He's going to be tackled by a pair of Patriots. Rizal Rux. This is a gain of 10. It'll be a first down for Parkview.
That time that Parkview offensive line was able to turn back the left side of this Marion defense and give Joiners some room.
2 minutes remaining in our opening quarter. Parkview leads Marion 7-0. Close game last year, 2019 was the final score. I formation again for Parkview. Rogers under center. Handoff goes to Jointer. Almost met at the line of scrimmage by Daniel. Now taking him down from behind is Brandon Calvert.
Nice play there by Calvert to get into the backfield and pull down Jointer.
Not quite a loss of a yard, but he did lose about a foot. So it'll still be second down and 10. Calvert able to wrestle Jointer down. Despite Parkview's size, the Patriot defenders have been able to get into the backfield. Just kind of be able to take advantage of those chances.
Seems like our line may be a little bit quicker at this point in the game.
Shotgun formation with a sniffer back in front of the running back. They fake a handoff. Oh. Almost sacked is Rogers. Rogers going to roll to the near side. He's able to break a tackle, gets a block, gets past the 20, and is knocked out of bounds at about the 18-yard line. They're going to mark him out at the 17.
Had an opportunity there at about the 35-yard line and just missed the tackle. And he was able to pick up another 12 yards.
So first and 10 for Parkview at the Marion 17. Patriots the last two games have gone down 14-0 to both Blytheville and Wynn. Now Parkview a chance to go up 14-0. I formation again for Parkview. The halfback is Pree. They hand it off to Pree. He's met at the line of scrimmage. I believe Scott was the first to get to him. Going to be marked at about the 15-yard line, gain of 2 by Parkview. Just enough time for one more play this quarter. About 30 seconds remaining. And Parkview will have to snap it one more time. They'll show I formation again. Pree is the halfback. It'll be a pass, though. Rogers looking to the far side of the field. Wide open is Feimster. Feimster is going to be knocked out of bounds just short of the goal line. He's going to be marked out at the 2.
I believe that was DeMarcus Williams over there that was just, an inch away from a pick 6. He got there just a little quicker. Could have taken that into the house.
First and goal for Parkview in between the 2 and 3 yard line. Again showing the I formation, tied in on the near side of the line. They hand it off to the fullback. It's a touchdown for Parkview. 14-0, 10 seconds remaining in our opening quarter.
Thomas McCauley went in untouched on that play. You almost have to anticipate him touching the ball when it gets down that close.
Yeah, they haven't used the I formation too much in this game, but the majority of the times that they have, they've handed it off to the fullback. So the kicker, Giovanni Riovelta, will attempt the extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is good. 14-0 in favor of Parkview here for Moore Memorial. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
For 31 years, JR&K Printing has been a full-service print and design company that specializes in full-color offset and digital printing. They produce everything from business cards, banners, and signs to vehicle wraps. JR&K Printing stands behind their printing and design services with guarantees on quality and pricing because they're sure you'll be satisfied. Learn more at jrkprinting.com. If you can think it, they can print it.
Nothing in favor of Parkview. We go down to our sideline reporter, Mark Price. We'll get to Mark in just a second. 14-0, the score in favor of Parkview. 10 seconds remaining in our opening quarter. Tyler Benton alongside me for this one is Ronnie Dye, pushing all the buttons, turning all the knobs, Landon West. Cameramen for this game include Mary Reese as the kick goes towards number 86, or is that Antonio Gray? He's able to break away from it is Antonio. He's coming to the near side of the field. He gets past the 40. Gets past another would-be tackler, gets pushed out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. That'll be the end of the first quarter. We take it down to our sideline reporter, Mark Price.
Right now, Marion is their own worst enemy. The defense finally had to stop. Special team, punt, muff. It's crazy right now. They got to settle down. I don't know if it's a big stadium or what it is, but they got to settle down. The team that they're playing is bigger than them, but not better than them. So they just got to get together and start playing Patriot football.
That was our sideline reporter, Mark Price. We also have one more report for him. Mark, what you got?
Marion was his own worst enemy on this drive, having to stop up around the 50-yard line, muff the punt, missed an interception, missed a couple tackles. They got to wrap up and learn it, take them to the ground. We spotted them 14. Looked like everybody we play, we spot 14 before we decide to play. We got to get out of that habit.
I was thinking the exact same thing. Seems like we're spotting team 14 points every time we play. Ronnie Dye on the call. Ronnie, what are your thoughts on that first quarter?
I agree with Mr. Price there. We've had our opportunities, just let a few of them get away, and it's tough spotting them 14 points like that. That's a tough place to be, but there's plenty of time left in this game.
Anthony Price, the running back with Daedric Kale, three wide receivers near side of the field. Kale fakes the handoff to Price. He's going to keep it himself, not able to get past the defensive line. Short gain, if any, on the run. I believe the line of scrimmage was the 47-yard line. They're going to mark him at the 48.
Kale had a little bit of pressure there and was forced to tuck and run. Much rather see him pass the ball, but that time that defense for Parkview was able to get in.
Patriots will show the same formation. Three wide receivers near side of the field. Doran, the lone receiver, on the far side. They fake the handoff to Price. The pass is complete to Caden Hunt. Hunt able to barrel his way past the 40-yard line. That's a fresh set of downs for Marion.
That's more of the look you want to see from this offense. Those little slash passes there inside, and just the receivers are doing a good job of getting extra yards after the catch.
Empty formation for Kale. Three wide receivers near side, two on the far. First and 10 for the Patriots at the Parkview 40. Kale looking to the far side of the field. He's got a man. It's Doran. Doran with a one-handed catch at the 20. He's at the 10-5. Touchdown, Patriots. Thomas Doran, a one-handed snag, and the Patriots are on the board.
Nice job there by Doran. Looked like the pass was just a little bit out of reach, and he stuck that one hand, his left hand out, and brought it back and was able to take it to the house.
Doran with the drop pass last week. A rough start to this game as well, but a one-handed snag and 6 points on the board. Dylan Pieri, the sophomore kicker. The snap is good, the hold is good, the kick is up, and the kick is good. Patriots on the board, 14-7 in favor of Parkview. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Having served Eastern Arkansas since 1966, Fidelity Bank is a financial staple in Crittenden County. With the main branch in West Memphis, Fidelity has multiple branches and ATMs in Marion and West Memphis to serve you. With their various online resources, Fidelity has you covered in a digital world. With SecureLock, you control your debit card usability. With their website and mobile banking app, you can do all that you want, including mobile check deposit, bill pay, money and external transfers, mobile alerts, and more. Check them out at FidelityBanker.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. A proud Patriot partner.
14-7 in favor of the Parkview Patriots here from War Memorial Stadium. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye, from just south of Markham Street in downtown Little Rock. Sophomore Dylan Pieri will kick it off once again for the Patriots. Back to receive, Feimster has been the man to look for Parkview so far.
This game could very well be tied, or we actually could have the lead right now. But just a few breaks went against us. However, there's signs of life here as they fought back and scored real quick here in the second quarter.
Feimster is the return man on the far side, Jointer on the near side for Parkview. Pierre sets to kick. This one will go to Feimster's side. Into the end zone, a great kickoff by the sophomore. We do also apologize for the language that may have gone onto the broadcast from Parkview's music. So we do apologize for any potential bad language that may have leaked through into the broadcast. Ace formation for Parkview, three wide receivers near side of the field. The handoff is a fake. Rogers tosses it to the running back. He's able to get past the 30, past the 40. Wrapped up by a Patriot, but still able to get to midfield. Big run. I believe that was Feimster.
That was Rux on the tackle.
Correction, that's number 8. That's Marcus Hill, senior wide receiver. Parkview in the home baby blues with the white lids. Patriots with navy helmets, white jerseys, and navy pants. Two wide receivers near side of the field for Parkview. The handoff goes to the running back. It's Jointer. Jointer to the far side of the field. Gets a block. Gets the end zone. What a run by James Jointer. Big blockers for Parkview, putting Parkview up 20-7.
50-yard run for Jointer on that play.
Revuelta, the kicker for Parkview. Chance to put Parkview up by 14. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is up. It's almost blocked, but it is good. 21-7 in favor of Parkview. Also a reminder, if you go to the Team Patriot St. Jude link available on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network Facebook page, I know it's up there. I put it up there this afternoon. So for a minimum $20 donation to St. Jude, you can enter in a shout-out that we will read over our live stream tonight. We've already got a list of some shout-outs that I'll be reading on later in the broadcast. These are some fun ones. I'm already looking at one in particular. Not naming names, but I will in a second. So 21-7 in favor of Parkview. You hate to point at one play as being the momentum swing, but that tipped touchdown has really kept everything in Parkview's favor.
That was a big play. It was an opportunity to intercept the ball and to start moving back in the opposite direction, but instead just goes in and out of the hands of Marion defender, and voila, just magically appears inside the hands of a receiver who is wide open at the 10-yard line.
Revuelta will be the kicker for Parkview. Antonio Grays is the return man on the far side of the field. They'll kick it to Grays. He'll receive it just in front of the 20-yard line. He's trying to make a move. He's going to roll back to the 20, trying to make some people miss. And he'll be tackled out of bounds at around the 25-yard line. They are going to mark him out at the 25. That's where the Patriots will set up, first and 10.
Antonio had a nice return on the last kickoff. This time didn't have near the room on that side, and he was able to get the ball out to the 25-yard line. Not bad. Not a bad start.
Patriots 1-1 on the season, winning in week 1 44-14 over the Blytheville Chickasaws, falling last week 27-21 to the talented Wynn Yellow Jackets. Parkview 0-1 on the season, a loss to Springdale 24-21 a week ago. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Kale. They fake a handoff. It will be a handed off to the running back. I believe that's Anthony Price. Price able to get past the line of scrimmage, almost into the linebackers. He's going to be tackled at about the 27-yard line. So second and 8 for Marion. Got to grab the binoculars from this high up with the silver numbers on the white jerseys. Kale looking near side of the field, has some pressure. He's going to step up, able to get past the 30s into the linebackers. Big tackle by number 32. That's Jordan Allison of Parkview.
Kale's being forced to run a little bit more than I'm sure Coach probably wants him to. I'm sure he would like to see him sling that ball out down the field, but the pressure's showing there tonight.
Third down and about 3. Line to gain is the 35. Price is the running back with Kale. 3 wide receivers near side of the field. Price now swapping to Kale's right. Kale hands it off to Price. Price met at the line of scrimmage, keeping his feet moving. Gets past the 35. That'll be a fresh set of downs. Going to be marked down at the 37.
Nice effort there by Price to get extra yards on that play as he was met and just kept his feet going and was able to get the first down.
Price had an elbow injury in offseason that kept him out from playing the benefit game at Stuttgart. He's got a brace on it now, but soldiering through it. 2 wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Price remains the running back. Kale looking to the far side of the field. The pass is just out of the outstretched arms of Doran.
That play was open again right there. Doran, I think he was looking ahead and just kind of lost concentration there for a second.
So second and 10 for the Patriots. Ball is at the 37. Line to gain is the Marion 47. 3 wide receivers near side of the field. Price remains the running back with Kale. Kale looking over to his coaches. Now we snap the ball. Looking to the near side of the field. Looking down the middle of the field. Throws to the running back. That's Price. Price able to get past the 45. Gets pushed out of bounds past midfield at the Parkview 48-yard line. Big gain, Anthony Price.
Nice protection that time by the offensive line and a nice read by Kale to get the ball out to Price on the wing for the first down.
We haven't seen much emphasis on the Patriot passing game so far. Patriots doing a pretty solid job of going to it so far in the first half. Price remains the running back with Kale. 3 wide receivers on the far side of the field. He's going to throw to Price. Price able to get past the 45. He's going to be knocked out of bounds just short of the 40-yard line at the 41. Line to gain is the 38.
Nice call there on that play as they go back to Price on this side.
2 wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Price, the running back. Ball is at the Parkview 41-yard line. Kale fakes the handoff. Kale looking to the near side of the field. He's got a man open. It's Caden Hunt. It's caught inside the 20. Let's see where they mark him out of bounds. They're going to put it at about the 12-yard line. Big gain. Caden Hunt, he comes up limping.
Perfect pass that time over the top by Kale. And nice catch there by Hunt as he takes it down to the 12-yard line.
2 wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Coming in for Caden Hunt, Carson Pieri. He's the far side slot receiver. Kale hands off to Price. Price getting to the line of scrimmage, now getting into the linebackers, keeps that feet moving. Again, a pretty sizable gain by Price, just keeping his feet moving.
Again, he got hit at the 9-yard line and pushed forward for another 2 yards. A nice job by the senior Price.
They mark him down at the 7. That'll be second down and 5. Patriots can get a fresh set of downs if they get to the 2-yard line. Sniffer back look for the Patriots. Handoff is to Price. Price loses the ball. The ball is on the ground, and Parkview recovers.
I was afraid of that. When he took that handoff, he didn't look real comfortable with it, and I never saw it come out, but then I saw the defense start to fall on it. Tough break for the Marion Patriots there.
coming away with it. I believe that's number 60. That would be Derek Harris. So first and 10 for Parkview. Ball spotted at their own 4-yard line. 7:49 remaining second quarter.
Tough break for Marion. That's two good drives in a row. And on the second drive there, unable to come up with points.
I formation for Parkview. They hand it off to the fullback. It was McCauley who was the fullback for the majority of this first half. And I believe that was who it was again. Short gain, if any. I believe they're going to mark it at about a 1-yard gain. They're marking him at the 5.
McCauley had 110 carries for 855 yards and 15 touchdowns last season.
I formation again for Parkview. They fake the handoff. Rogers rolling to the far side of the field. Had a man open, just threw it in front of him. Friday the 13th here in Little Rock for the last time. It won't happen again until 2049. We have a full moon just over the main building at UAMS here at Little Rock. Full moon on a Friday the 13th. You superstitious, Mr. Dye?
Oh, no, not at all. I've seen all the movies, though.
I formation for Parkview, third down and 9. Line to gain is the Parkview 14. Parkview making sure they have the play right. The handoff will go to the halfback. It's Jointer. Jointer trying to get past the 10-yard line, able to shed a tackle. Line to gain is the 14, and he crosses it. They're going to mark him at the 16. Fresh set of downs for Parkview.
They had an opportunity there in the backfield and just couldn't get to him. He was able to bounce out for extra yards on the play.
McCauley checks out of the game. Feimster checks back in. Parkview has gone under center, especially with that I formation a lot tonight, especially with those big blockers that they have. One of the rare teams we'll see with a tight end. Rogers rolling to the near side of the field. He's going to throw to the near side. He's got a man open. It's almost picked off. Nice. Almost coming away with the interception. That's Brandon Hayes.
Nice play by Hayes there.
They're going to come away with one.
They're so close. They are so close. That's about 3 or 4 now that they have had their hands on and had an opportunity to pick off. And a couple of those could have been pick sixes.
6:42 remaining in our opening half of play. Parkview leads 21-7. Landon Rogers, the junior quarterback, under center. They hand it off to the running back. It was Jointer for the majority of the first quarter. He's able to get past the 20. He'll be knocked down at the 21-yard line. That would be a gain of 5.
That was a nice move there by Jointer on that play as he was approaching some traffic and just kind of shifted to his right a little bit and gained a few more yards on the play.
Freshman running back Darian Bennett on the run for Parkview.
Or Bennett, rather. Any Ken?
Afraid not. Two wide receivers far side. There's a tight end on the line on the near side for Rogers. A lot of pressure. Oh. Rogers is going to escape for a moment, though. It gets past the 25. He's going to be knocked down at around the 30. That's a fresh set of downs. Just scrambling. Patriots had the pressure, just not able to wrap up.
Nice call there on defense. It was there. They had the pressure. Just Rogers was able to elude the tackler and gain some yards.
Ball's at the Parkview 26, 5:49 remaining in our opening half. Two wide receivers either side of the field. Correction, that's a tight end on the far side of the line. The handoff to the running back, that looks like McCauley. McCauley will get past the original line of scrimmage, make his way to about the 32.
I think that was Dylan Chapel maybe on the tackle. It's hard to see the number, but it looked like 54 maybe.
Public address announcer making sure to add Thomas the Train McCauley. Not sure if there's any relations to Wes McCauley. Gigantic referee for the NHL.
Oh.
And the far side guard jumped for Parkview. Yep, the far side guard jumping for Parkview, that triggered number 41, Drew Granger. So a false start for Parkview, that sets up second and about 12. Line to gain is the Parkview 39-yard line. Parkview will hand it off to the running back. It's McCauley. He's met at the line of scrimmage. Going to wrestle his way forward. Now a flag comes out late.
I believe they're going to get possibly a face mask there. It looked like he might have inadvertently grabbed the face mask.
The Patriot on the far side is number 12. That's Jaquelin Daniel. The referees are meeting. Now here's the call. Yep, he called it, face mask against the Patriots.
You could tell by the way his helmet kind of twisted there when on the tackle that it just didn't look right. And looks like they give him the 15 variety.
Yep, 15-yard penalty against Marion. Last week it was a 5-yard penalty. Two wide receivers near side, Sniffer back on the near side as well. They hand it, correction, it's a fake and a throw to the near side of the field. We have a flag out at around the Marion 47-yard line. This is going to be a hold against Parkview.
That's what he's going to say. It's going to be a hold probably against that blocker.
So the flag's out at around the Marion 48. That would push this back to about the Parkview 42. If they're going by the spot of the foul. Yep, so a hold against one of the near side receivers, and that does push Parkview back to their own 42. The line to gain is about the Marion 45.
That was a great call there by Parkview's offense. The play was open. And just fortunate for us, they held on the play.
Also, I'll go ahead and clarify it. If I say Patriots tonight, I'm referring to Marion. Three wide receivers far side of the field. Rodgers is going to throw to the far side. Ball is complete around midfield. The receiver able to get past midfield. Believe that's number 36. That would be Aaron Outley.
That's their tight end. Yeah, I was expecting them to throw to him some in this game. He's a 6'4", 240 junior, and he had 27 receptions for 322 yards last season.
Gain of about 11 at second and two. Parkview has to get to the Marion 45 to extend the drive. Two wide receivers either side of the field. They hand off to the running back that looks like Jointer. Jointer nice. Going to be met at about the the line of scrimmage for that play. It'll be third down and about a long one.
Jaquelin Daniel, one of the players in on that tackle. Nice play there to shut down that run.
Third and one for Parkview, 3:30 remaining in our opening half. 21-7, the Parkview advantage. Marion will get the ball to start our second half. I formation and the far side guard jumped again. That'll cost Parkview 5 more yards.
You saw the linebacker starting to come in and filling up those gaps, and the offensive line kind of got a little jumpy on that.
The offensive line can hear footsteps too. We say that about receivers, but they can hear footsteps too. So instead of third and inches for Parkview, make it third down and 6. They're back at their own 49-yard line. They need to get to the Patriot 46 if they want to extend the drive. Three wide receivers far side of the field for Rodgers. Marion showing blitz. Rogers hands it off to the running back he's met in the backfield. This is going to be a loss of yards for Parkview, loss of about two.
Antonio Graves gets back there and has a tackle for loss on that play for Marion.
Great play by Graves to wrap up Jointer, nowhere to go. Now under 2:30 remaining in the opening half. Patriots will get the ball back. Again, apologies to the Parkview punter. Don't have his name on roster, but it is number 87, so he will receive the low snap. It took a bounce before it got to him. This is going to be a low punt. It'll bounce just shy of the 25. It almost touches Doran. Doran saying he did not touch it, and it'll be down by Parkview at about the 13. Awful close again. The call for something like that would be Peter. If you hear that, you got to stay away from the ball. Doran not reading the punts well. A low punt again by Parkview.
And again, the snap bounces to that punter for the third time in this game. Can't help but think we're going to get back there and get one of those.
1:59 for the Patriot offense remaining in our opening half. Patriots trailing by 14 to Parkview. But they do get the ball back to start the second half of play. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Kale. They fake the handoff to Price. He's going to throw down the middle of the field. Intended wide receiver that looks like Doran. Just passed the arms of Doran. Grayson, that may be number 17. That's 17. Caleb Catt.
Yes.
So just past Caleb Catt. Second and 10 for the Patriots. 1:55 remaining in our opening half. Three wide receivers far side of the field for Kale. Anthony Price, the running back. Fakes the handoff to Price. Pass is complete to Catt. Cat able to get to about the 25-yard line. That'll be a fresh set of downs. They went right back to Cat.
Nice pitch and catch there. From Kale to Cat.
Three receivers near side. Price the running back. They fake it again to Price. They throw it again to Cat. Cat able to get to about the 35-yard line. This will be another fresh set of downs. Caleb Catt has gotten three targets and two first downs.
Nice move there after the catch to pick up another 3 or 4 yards. With all the attention going to him, it might open up something here for one of the other guys here on the next few plays.
Three receivers far side of the field for Kale. Ball is at the Marion 37-yard line. Again, faking the handoff to Price. Again, going back to Catt. Catt this time will be wrapped up at about the 45-yard line, close to the sticks. Almost had his third first down in three catches. I guess until Parkview stops it, keep running it.
If it's not broke, don't fix it, right?
Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Price is the running back. Throwing to the far side this time, it's Maury Cage. Maury pass midfield. Maury to about the 45. They'll mark him down at the Parkview 45. First target we see to Maury Cage. Now we get a timeout. Or no, they're just moving the chains. No, we do have a timeout on the far side. Parkview will burn it. 1 minute remaining in our opening half of play. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
At Ford of West Memphis, quality comes first. They believe that with high quality comes happy customers. That's why if you're in the market for a new car, truck, or SUV, you should stop by Ford of West Memphis. Their community presence is strong as ever with their commitment to the Marion Patriots. Recently, Ford of West Memphis' efforts helped to raise over $7,000 for the Lady Patriot cheerleaders. At Ford of West Memphis, they have a strong and committed sales staff with many years of experience satisfying their customers' needs. Feel free to browse their inventory online, request more information about vehicles, set up a test drive, or inquire about financing. A proud Patriot partner.
Mitchell Family Medicine. 21-7 the score in favor of Parkview. Exactly 60 seconds remaining in our opening half of play. Patriots on a little bit of a drive, though. Three big catches for Caleb Catt.
We're moving the ball in this contest. Just been unfortunate a few times and putting points on the board.
Three wide receivers near side of the field for Cale. Price remains the running back. Doran, the lone side receiver on the far side. They throw again to Caleb Catt, his fourth catch of the game. The ball is out. Ball is fumbled by Catt, recovered by Marion, though. No. Yeah, so they will say Marion does keep it. Oh, no, they give it back to Parkview. So Caleb Catt fumbling. It looked like one of the offensive linemen for Marion had it. But coming out of the pile with the ball was number 50 for Parkview. That's Favian Delph. Now the Patriot coach is trying to argue that they were the ones that initially had the ball.
Another tough break. Refs
will meet at the 40.
Unless this is overturned, another tough break for Marion.
I believe this will stay with Parkview.
Yeah, it doesn't look like they're changing anything here. Coach Hughes, Houston's making a plea there, but to no avail.
So it is first and 10 for Parkview. Rogers looking to the near side of the field. The receiver pushes off, but still able to make the snag. It looked like he was pushing off the near side corner.
Here's a replay.
No flag. Yeah, it looked like Outley pushed the near side corner. No flags and a fresh set of downs for Parkview. 36 seconds remaining. One timeout left in the half for Parkview. Three down linemen for the Patriots. A low pass to the far side of the field. I believe the intended receiver was Feenster. Incomplete. Feenster has been the go-to guy for Parkview. So second and 10 for Parkview now. 27 seconds remaining. They do still have one timeout remaining. Patriots with all three. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Rogers. Jointer is the running back. Rogers rolling to the far side of the field. The ball is complete to Outley. Outley hurdles a defender, makes it to the 20, past the 15, inside the 15 at the 13-yard line. Big gain for Aaron Outley.
And that got the crowd up and at him over there on that far side.
Anthony Price called for a flag in week one for hurdling a defender. No flag. Or actually, there are flags down.
There is
down.
A flag on the field.
A flag is down at about the 24-yard line.
There's one at the 15 as well. He just picked it up.
I do remember Anthony Price was called for hurdling a defender in the game against Blyville. That may be what this flag is about here. An illegal procedure against Parkview. So first down. 17 seconds remaining in the opening half. Penalty is for an illegal procedure. It is still a first down for Parkview. Three wide receivers near side of the field. Jointer, the running back, with Rogers. Rogers looking over to his coach, is now looking to receive the snap. Looking to the near side of the field. Ball is incomplete. Intended for number 8, that's Marcus Hill. It'll be second and 10 for Parkview. 10 seconds remaining.
Nice pressure that time by Marion to get in on the quarterback and cause him to rush his throw a little bit.
I believe Parkview is outside of field goal range. So if they don't get any closer, we may just see a throw to the end zone here in a second, 10 seconds remaining in our half. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Rogers. Rogers looking to the near side. He's pressured. Pass is incomplete, intended for Outley. In coverage for Marion, D'Antonio Moore.
Again, pressure on the quarterback that time. We would have third down coming up.
Third and 10 for Parkview. Ball is at the Marion 26. 7 seconds remaining and two downs for Parkview. Maybe two throws to the end zone. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Parkview. Jointer is the running back. Rogers looking to the near side of the field. He's going to be pressured. He's going to be brought down. 1 second remaining in the half, and Parkview will burn their timeout.
Yeah, nice job that time by the Marion Patriot defense.
Quarterback keeper by Rogers. He's able to get back to the line of scrimmage. Big guy with that kind of size, even with that, able to get back to the line of scrimmage. 1 second remaining, so we'll keep the action here in our first half of play. Wind slowly starting to pick up here at War Memorial. The flags in the north end zone are waving pretty hard.
I know you've mentioned that full moon already tonight, but that thing's moving up a little bit above the lights, and it's really standing out over there.
A lot of noise coming from UAMS across the street. Again, Patriot Volleyball 4-0 in conference play so far this season. Big five-set win last night at Paragould. First time they've taken a set at Paragould since 2016, so an impressive five-set win for the Patriots over the Rams. They'll be at home all this week. Tuesday night, they'll be at Patriot Volleyball Gymnasium to take on the Jonesboro Golden Hurricane. And then Thursday night, they will be at Patriot Arena to take on the West Memphis Blue Devils. So we will see the field goal kicker, Giovanni Riavelta. This will be about a 42-yard field goal attempt. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is blocked. Patriots will jump on it just shy of the 40-yard line, and that will be the end of our first half of play. Patriots have left a lot of points on the board, but able to steal 3 points away from Parkview before the end of the half. We got a 20-minute halftime. Patriots trail by 14. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Mitchell Family Medicine provides exceptional medical care and compassionate hope to the whole family. We accept patients of all ages and are here to serve you. We take care of chronic conditions, annual physicals, acute care medical needs, and so much more. For your convenience, we have an in-house x-ray, lab, and pharmacy. Come see us at our new location at 924 Highway 77 in Marion, or find us online at MitchellFamilyMedicine.com. Mitchell Family Medicine. You can depend on us for life.
Are you on the hunt for a quality late model vehicle at a great wholesale price? Not interested in gimmicks and high pressure sales? Want to complete your purchase in minutes instead of hours? Then stop searching and come by King Motor Company in Marion. Located just 10 miles from Memphis, King Motor Company is not your typical sales environment or car buying experience.
Our customers are our friends, and our friends are our customers. No pressure, no haggle, no dock fee, just quality vehicles at wholesale prices. Come shop with us. We'll save you money.
When you need great pizza, where do you go? Pizza Pro. When you need delicious salads, where do you go? Pizza Pro. And when you need awesome wings, where do you go? Pizza Pro. Pizza Pro is your go-to choice for pizza, salads, and wings, and soon they'll have sub sandwiches as well. Pizza Pro is open from 11 to 10 Sunday through Thursday and until 11 on Friday and Saturday nights on Highway 77 in Marion. Pizza Pro, the official pizza of the Marion Patriots.
A proud Patriot partner.
27 years, one family owner, and one driving philosophy at Holly Chevrolet.
Easy, simple people to do business with. We make it as simple as possible, easy to get in and out of. The integrity that we have here at our dealership, that's what we're all about, and that's what we want to sell here at Holly Chevrolet.
We want to take care of our customers the same way we would like to be taken care of if we were doing business somewhere else.
How do you get that across to your customers?
Treat you like family.
Trust, integrity, honesty. They're why Holly Chevrolet is your wise choice in Marion, Arkansas.
Holly Chevrolet, a proud Patriot partner.
Welcome home at Premier Bank of Arkansas, where they exist to serve all of your financial needs. But unlike the other banks, they do it with a down-home touch. Whether your dog needs a bone at the drive-thru window, or maybe your child needs a toy while mommy and daddy handle business. Of course, who doesn't like free candy every now and then? Maybe you need a loan. Or perhaps just someone to root for the Patriots with you.
Go Patriots!
Go Pats!
Go Patriots!
With locations in West Memphis and Marion, they are here for you. They are
your hometown bank. Go Patriots!
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender, a proud Patriot partner. Have you had a burger at the Shake Shack lately? I mean a real burger, certified Angus beef. Did you know that Tacker Shake Shack has over 20 different burgers to choose from with lots and lots of different toppings? Try the John Wayne, maybe the mac and cheese burger, or pick your favorite toppings right off their menu. Feeling brave and really hungry? Take the Sultana Burger Challenge. Then experience one of their delicious desserts. They have homemade pies, shakes, and ice cream. And there's no doubt that their breakfast is the best around. Dine in, phone in, drive through, and delivery now available at Tacker Shake Shack, a proud Patriot partner.
And welcome back to War Memorial Stadium. Patriots trailing the Parkview Patriots 21-7. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye, here from War Memorial Stadium. It's hard to describe that first half of play.
It was a tough first half. Offense was moving the ball a little bit, just had some tough breaks there, a couple fumbles, lost the fumbles there, and Parkview came away with two big plays, a 51-yard should have been intercepted, and instead it was deflected, and the offensive player caught it, and then the 50-yard run by the player, a joiner there in the second quarter.
Patriots have had some good looks so far on offense. Difference has been a couple of fumbles on the Parkview side of the field.
That's exactly right. That's what we've seen so far. It's unfortunate for us. We're playing pretty decent ball. Just have some tough breaks there.
Marion will get the ball to start the second half of play. Our apologies, we won't show the band for this on the request of the band director, Mr. Headley, but they will be playing a halftime show featuring the music of Queen. You can see it at Patriot Stadium at any home games this Friday as well. It's a fantastic show filled with great music from Queen. I mean, yeah. How can you beat that? But again, Marion trailing the Parkview Patriots 21-7 here at halftime. Any impressions, anything you want to see? Patriots will start the ball with the second half. Anything you want to see in the second half?
Yeah, I would like to see us continue to pass the ball well. I think Kale has thrown it well tonight. The receivers have caught the ball and have gotten some yards after the catch. Just got to hang on to it.
All right, so up next in the halftime show, we'll have all of the Patriot partners, but we also have a special message from the Hometown Showdown crew that we recorded at MHS Cyber Studios. So, for Ronnie, this is Tyler. We'll be right back with some more Patriot football. Coming up on this week's edition of the PatCast, we sit down with head football coach.
Because it's accommodating businesses of all sizes. So, Mr. Marcus Felix, I'd like to start with you. Your corporation, ServiceMaster, has a huge presence in the Mid-South, new HQ in downtown Memphis, and has done a lot. What does the Hometown Showdown mean to ServiceMaster?
Sure. ServiceMaster Facility Maintenance is my local franchise. We're a strong advocate of community service and education in general. We partnered with various outfits like the Kappas of Memphis, with the Kappa Days of Caring, where we did STEM programs over the last couple of years. We actually participated in the Marion Parade here a couple of years ago. We built a float, came out to the community. We partnered with companies like Nike to do trash pickups in the local community. So anytime we can get involved in any community avenue, that's always a win-win for us.
And so what is your relationship with the Hometown Showdown football game? What does that cover?
Well, we're sponsoring. We're halftime sponsors this year. We're proud to be that. You should look for us at the tailgate party. Of course, Fred Leonard halftime will be out, and we'll be tailgating along with other businesses. And it actually has a very personal aspect with us too, because you know, ownership group, they have kids in the Marion School District. I went to the Marion School District class, Marion School System, I'm sorry, class of 87. And also we have personnel in our office that have children in the West Memphis School District. So we're just proud to be a part.
So there's a family aspect to this for Service Master. Well, that's great. Mr. Cordy Woodson of I Would Fix It, fairly new small business in Marion. You have a unique role with the Hometown Showdown and the website. Tell us about that.
So this year I decided, you know, that, you know, it would be a good time for I Would Fix It to take that step and start getting involved in the community. So as you stated, we opened in Marion in 2017. We took time to get ourselves established, and then this year we felt like was a good opportunity for us to get involved in the community. So we're doing, you know, a few other community things, but definitely wanted to be involved in this as well. One reason, I have daughters in the school district. I have one daughter that's actually in high school. So, you know, to her, you know, it's pretty cool that my dad's logo is, you know, is going to be involved. But definitely just wanted to showcase also like some of our talents, you know, some of the things that we do and we offer as, you know, as our capabilities as a small business to the community.
Okay, so having a daughter who I taught in the Marion School District, and knowing how much this game means to both the Marion School District and the West Memphis School District, how does that benefit your small business?
So that's a good question. Recently, we've just noticed a lot more, you know, foot traffic in the store. So we're noticing, now we went from, of course, you know, to opening the doors to like not having one to two people in every week. We're now noticing we're getting a lot more phone calls, we're getting a lot more people that show up. We're getting a lot of messages on our site. It's just, you know, business is definitely picking up. And one of the things that we do here is that, yeah, we've seen your logo. We see that, you know, you're definitely involved in the community. You know, we talk to people and we've heard, you know, good things. So
well, that's good. We're certainly glad that the name of Marion School District can, you know, be a benefit to our local businesses. And now Fidelity Bank, a proud Patriot partner, has been here for forever, it seems like. And has that established reputation as, you know, the bank for Crittenden County.
Right.
What does this mean to Fidelity Bank, the Hometown Showdown? Because you've got branches in both towns.
Right. So at Fidelity Bank, we truly believe in embodying a real community bank, and we have for over 50 years. So to us, both school districts, the Marion and the West Memphis School District, they are the heart of this community. And, you know, these are our customers, these families, these kids, they're our customers, and we don't take that for granted. And so the Hometown Showdown is a perfect platform for us to show the community just how committed we are to the growth of this area. And not only that, but it gives us the opportunity to show these families and these kids how grateful we are for this area and this community to let us grow and thrive and, you know, essentially be its longest standing locally owned bank. So this is, the Hometown Showdown is just a perfect platform for us, and it's something that we are very excited to be a part of.
Maybe what specifically, maybe for you or mm-hmm. as a representative of Fidelity Bank, mm-hmm. what part of this do you really take a lot of pride in or look forward to the most?
So for us, we're all about the county. We love Crittenden County. We are committed to Crittenden County. We are always looking for ways to dive in the community. And so to have an event that embodies both school districts and represents both school districts really serves us well, because we're not here to pick sides. We're here to bring the county together, and we're here to just essentially grow this area. And so that's really what we want to represent.
Okay, so with this Hometown Showdown, it wasn't always this big.
Right.
It took a lot of vision, and it took a lot of leadership from the campus, Mr. Grandin Gray.
Right.
This year it has the title sponsor with Fred Leonard. Mm-hmm. How do you see this as a platform for your business? Maybe with ServiceMaster, what do you believe that this game has to offer for your business?
Well, first of all, you know, like you know, some of the other patrons said, that it actually gets you exposure as far as you know, exposing your name and your brand, you know, getting your brand out there where people see that you're much more than just a business. You're part mm-hmm. of the community. You know, so that's important for us, and then that in turn, you actually get people actually saying things like this gentleman said, that hey, I saw you guys at the parade, or in this case, we hope, you know, out at the game, and interacting and shaking hands, and just being part of the community in general. So I mean, it's always a win for us to be able to get that type of exposure. Mm-hmm.
And either of you, it seems like this builds some kind of element of trust when your brands are seen at this local level. This is obviously a huge event for Crittenden County, the largest sporting event. Mm-hmm. But there's something very, very personal about it too. I don't know if it's the rivalry, you know, the y'all versus us, or if it's the coming together saying, you know, I can support my team. What element do you look forward to being created with this event and your businesses?
So for me, it's, you know, the opportunity to give back is super important. So just being able to give back, being able to be part of, like I said, the building of this county. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, I've been here 10 years. I want to see it grow. I mean, it's grown. I want to continue to see it grow. I want to be here for a while. So I think those aspects just, you know, they all, you know, come into play when I think about, you know, what we're doing. So
it seems like over the past couple of years we've gotten some positive momentum in the county itself, mm-hmm. And this game has grown with that. If you were looking into your crystal ball, Shelby Joe, mm-hmm. Where do you see this going as someone who's been with it since day one?
This particular event?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, I just really admire what Grand and Gray and Fred Leonard have done, and their whole crew. To me, I personally just really enjoy the camaraderie of everyone coming together before the event. You've got some Marion fans, you've got some Blue Devil fans, but at the end of the day, we can all sit there and we can network and we can hang out with the kids and we can hang out with school teachers, and we can come together for one common goal before the game, and that is to strengthen the community.
So there's a lot of a huge upside for local businesses to being a part of this event. I know sponsorships are still available. If you want to check that out, it's at hometownshowdownar.com. Check out the St. Jude Game Day Give Back. We're all wearing our pins and representing the efforts of the St. Jude Game Day Give Back so that we as a community can reach the $10,000 goal of uniting for the cause of St. Jude, because that's just something that we all can get behind. Well, I appreciate you three coming by today, sitting down with us and talking about the Hometown Showdown. It's been a pleasure, and we look forward to seeing you you know, at Hamilton Schultz on game day.
Good
to see y'all. We'll be right back.
AMS Realty is a privately owned real estate company specializing in property management. They currently manage over 300 rental units in Crittenden County. If your rental property has become a burden, give them a call and let them tell you how they can relieve the burden. They have no upfront fees, and their monthly management fee is based solely on rents collected. If they don't collect the rent, they don't get paid. Give AMS Realty a call at 739-3000.
Hello, I'm Pastor James Nichols at First Marion. We're under construction in our sanctuary building. We're excited about the changes that are on the horizon, but more than that, we want to help you construct your life in a way that honors God and brings blessings to you. We want to invite you to join us on November the 3rd at 10 o'clock as we dedicate our service to the ministries of Marion. Come and join us at First Marion, the church in the curve.
Wouldn't it be great if there was a one-stop shop for all of your automotive, hardware, lawn and garden, and farm supply needs? It just so happens that such a place exists right here in Marion. Cliff's Auto Parts. Family owned for 32 years, they can cut keys of all kinds, including transponder keys. They also create custom hydraulic hoses, and they carry a wide range of lawnmower parts. If they don't have it, they can get it. Cliff's Auto Parts, 120 Block Street in Marion.
At Faulkner Eye Clinic, they strive to treat you the way that you want to be treated, with top-quality eye care by use of technology and experience. Quality to them means being thorough and finding out how you use your vision, thus helping your efficiency. The long-term health of your eyes and vision need to be protected. That's why pictures of your retina and scans of your eyes can be important parts of protecting your vision from health issues like diabetes and high blood pressure, or vision issues like cataracts, macular degeneration, or glaucoma. Faulkner Eye Clinic. They want to help you help yourself. A proud Patriot partner.
21-17, our score here at halftime for Moore Memorial Stadium. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye.
Now, kickoff for that game is 7 o'clock.
Oh, 21-7. Correction on that score at halftime. It's been a long day. 21-7, our score in favor of Parkview here at War Memorial Stadium. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye. Running the camera and all the things that you're seeing on screen, that's Landon West. Also running our cameras, we have Chandler White, McGuire Rappard, and Mary Reese. So far, story of the game has been the Patriots have just shot themselves in the foot, to be quite honest.
Exactly right. We've had two lost fumbles. We've moved the ball really well on some nice passing by Kale, but just fumbled it away there a couple of times. And, you know, wish we had those back. We could be tied up very, very easily right now. But
a good microcosm for this game so far has to be the first touchdown by Parkview. Patriots almost having an interception. It gets tipped into the air. A look what I found snag by Feimster, and it's 7-0 Parkview early.
Right. We were just talking about it at halftime. We should have three interceptions at this point in the game. We're getting our hands on the ball, and we're stopping their run, which is what they're known for. And so if we could just put it all together here in the second half, we could very easily turn this game around.
One thing I am liking about the Patriots with the injury bug that we've had so far, specifically with players like Slade Webb and Kentrell Jones, for these players to step up like this has been pretty big, but we can't afford the fumbles. We can't afford the dropped passes like this. So it's got to be overcoming the injury bug so far.
Right, and ideally we get the ball first in the second half, and ideally we want to go down and put the ball in the end zone just to shorten the lead here for Parkview, and that way we don't have to be forced to pass the ball the remainder of the game. We can get maybe Price going on the ground and kind of open things up a little bit later on with the pass.
Patriots have built a little bit of momentum there just before the end of the first half. Hope to build on that a little bit. We've seen receivers like Caleb Catt. He's come in and had a few snags. So hopefully he can build on that momentum going into the second.
Exactly right. And, of course, we don't want to see Kale running the ball as much as he did the first half. The offensive line has been doing pretty good as far as providing security for him. But there's been times where he's been forced out of the pocket, and you'd much rather see him throwing it than running it.
So that's it for our halftime show here. We're getting ready for the second half of action. Just behind us, just south of Markham Street in downtown Little Rock. For Ronnie, this is Tyler. We'll see you in the second half.
When you want hometown health care, you want Marion Minor Medical, a proud Patriot partner. Finner Physical Therapy has been serving Crittenden County since opening in Marion in 2007. 11 years later, you can find them throughout eastern Arkansas. Their treatment options include physical, occupational, and speech therapy services at all five of their locations. Other therapy services include sports injury rehab and prevention. Finner Physical Therapy further boasts the only aquatic therapy pool in the region at their West Memphis Delta Orthopedics and Sports Medicine location. Does your student athlete have a recent injury that needs rehab or even a past injury that needs strengthening?
Finner Physical Therapy got me back on the court stronger than ever.
Call the Finner Physical Therapy team to find out more about how we work to strengthen the Delta. Finner Physical Therapy, a proud Patriot partner.
For 31 years, JR&K Printing has been a full-service print and design company that specializes in full-color offset and digital printing. They produce everything from business cards, banners, and signs to vehicle wraps. JR&K Printing stands behind their printing and design services with guarantees on quality and pricing because they're sure you'll be satisfied. Learn more at jrkprinting.com. If you can think it, they can print it.
Having served Eastern Arkansas since 1966, Fidelity Bank is a financial staple in Crittenden County. With the main branch in West Memphis, Fidelity has multiple branches and ATMs in Marion and West Memphis to serve you. With their various online resources, Fidelity has you covered in a digital world. With SecureLock, you control your debit card usability. With their website and mobile banking app, you can do all that you want, including mobile check deposit, bill pay, money and external transfers, mobile alerts, and more. Check them out at FidelityBanker.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. A proud Patriot partner. At Ford of West Memphis, quality comes first. They believe that with high quality comes happy customers. That's why if you're in the market for a new car, truck, or SUV, you should stop by Ford of West Memphis. Their community presence is strong as ever with their commitment to the Marion Patriots. Recently, Ford of West Memphis' efforts helped to raise over $7,000 for the Lady Patriot cheerleaders. At Ford of West Memphis, they have a strong and committed sales staff with many years of experience satisfying their customers' needs. Feel free to browse their inventory online, request more information about vehicles, set up a test drive, or inquire about financing. A proud Patriot partner.
Mitchell Family Medicine provides exceptional medical care and compassionate hope to the whole family. We accept patients of all ages and are here to serve you. We take care of chronic conditions, annual physicals, acute care medical needs, and so much more. For your convenience, we have an in-house x-ray, lab, and pharmacy. Come see us at our new location at 924 Highway 77 in Marion, or find us online at MitchellFamilyMedicine.com. Mitchell Family Medicine. You can depend on us for life.
Some shout-outs from our St. Jude Give Back. We start with the Piercy family. Congratulations, MHS cheerleaders, class of 2020, and Clancy Piercy. Love the family. Sandra and Steve Halley. Big thanks to Coach Keith Houston. Thanks for all you do for MSD. Cindy French says, dear Spencer's moms, your turn to donate to St. Jude. Jeff Bennett writes, big thanks to the Arkansas Hall of Fame chain crew. You're the best. Lisa and Sean Pieri, happy game day. Dylan and Carson Pieri, love mom and dad. Both have gotten some playing time today, by the way. And also, just coming in, we have a $20 shout-out from Jeff Bennett. Shout-out to Jeff, Renee, Ronnie, and Ann, and also Julie and Brian watching the game at my house right now.
Nice. Hey, I want to give a shout-out to our band.
Oh, yes.
Very, very good performance at halftime, one that you should look forward to seeing there at Marion Patriot Stadium.
Giovanni Revuelta, the kickoff man for the Parkview Patriots. Antonio Graves is the return man on the far side of the field. That's who they've kicked to all day so far, and that's the side they'll kick to again. It's taken by a Patriot returner at about the 35. He'll make his way past midfield, and the Patriots will start off on the Parkview side of the field here in the second half. The return man is number 41. That is Drew Granger. We've seen him in some tight end looks in that sniffer back spot.
I think Granger surprised them by catching that and then taking off with it.
So they're going to say he stepped out at midfield, so they'll still be starting off on their side of the field, but still really good possession to start the second half. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Kale. Price is the running back to Kale's left. Far side lone receiver is Thomas Doran. They hand off to Price. He'll get into the linebackers. He's going to be wrapped up by the far side end. Gain of about 6 on the run by Price.
Nice run there by Price. We need that to kind of open up things here in the second half.
Second and 4 for the Patriots. Ball spotted at the Parkview 44-yard line. Patriots trailing by 14, but they do have the ball here to start our second half. Three wide receivers again near side for Kale. Price is the running back to Kale's right. They hand it off again to Price. Price has himself awfully close to the line to gain.
Again, a nice hole there up the middle for Anthony Price. And it's going to be enough for the first down.
They are going to move the chains. They're going to put it at the Parkview 40. Patriots moving so far on this opening possession here in the second half. Again, also want to apologize not showing the band during their performance during the first half. That's on the request of the band director, Mr. Medley. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Kale. Price remains the running back with Kale. He's now to Kale's right, or sorry, his left side. Kale looking to the near side of the field. He's going to be hit from behind. That's a big sack for Parkview. Wrapping up Kale, that's number 54 for Parkview, Jaden Allison.
That was a tough play for Kale there. He never really had a chance to look downfield.
Got hit on the blind side as well. Loss of 7 on the sack. Second and 17 for the Patriots. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Price remains the running back. Price in motion to the far side of the field. Kale looking downfield. He's got a man wide open. It's caught at about the 32-yard line. Line to gain is the 30. They'll mark him at about the 31. They're putting the ball down at the 30. That should be a fresh set of downs. DJ Johnson, his first catch of the game. Two wide receivers again either side of the field. It's going to be third down and inches for the Patriots. Anthony Price gets the first down, gets past the 25. Third and inches turns into first and 10 for the Patriots. Patriots on the move.
Nice hard run there by Price. He was not going to be stopped on that play.
So first and 10 for Marion. Two wide receivers either side of the field. Ball is at the Parkview 22-yard line. Price remains the running back with Kale. They hand it off to Price. Gets into the linebackers. Again, a pretty sizable gain. This one's going to be about 5 yards.
Another hard run by Price there. You notice he went into traffic about 2 yards before that, and then he continued moving and gained about 4 on the play.
They place it at the 17. It's second and 5. Two wide receivers again on either side of the field for Kale. Kale looking down the middle of the field. It's caught at the 5. It's Caden Hunt, and it's a Patriots touchdown.
Those runs by Price set that play up. He kept gaining yards and gaining yards, and finally it opened up for Hunt to catch that pass.
Caden Hunt last week, again, I said it in the first half, kind of felt like he put the game on his shoulders. Coach Keith Houston very quick to say this is a team game. Do not put any kind of a loss on one person, but a huge response by Caden Hunt. You knew the way he was feeling after that. You would expect that. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is up. And the kick is good. Patriots trail by 7. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Are you on the hunt for a quality late model vehicle at a great wholesale price? Not interested in... Are you on the hunt for a quality late model vehicle at a great wholesale price? Not interested in gimmicks and high-pressure sales? Want to complete your purchase in minutes instead of hours? Then stop searching and come by King Motor Company in Marion. Located just 10 miles from Memphis, King Motor Company is not your typical sales environment or car buying experience.
Our customers are our friends, and our friends are our customers. No pressure, no haggle, no dock fee, just quality vehicles at wholesale prices. Come shop with us. We'll save you money.
Patriots, a big response here to start the second half. Caden Hunt answering with a touchdown catch to trim the Parkview lead back to 7.
Nice job by Coach Houston there in the locker room at the half to make some adjustments, and they come out with several running plays up the middle to open up a few passes and get the ball into the end zone.
We'll have a update from our sideline reporter, Mark Price, in just a second following the Patriot touchdown. Dylan Pieri will be the kickoff. Mark Price.
Good mixture of running plays, pass plays. They've decided they're going to try to play this game without giving up any more points. Keep in mind, the Patriots have dropped 5 or 6 interceptions, fumbled the ball on the 4-yard line or the 3-yard line, and basically helped Parkview to this lead. So if they calm down and start playing like they need to play, we'll be okay.
Dylan Pieri's kick goes out of the back of the end zone. another touchback for the sophomore. Last year starting as a freshman, now coming in and putting the ball consistently out of the back of the end zone. First and 10 for Parkview. Ball spotted at their own 20-yard line. Rogers under center. Rogers had to keep it himself. Big play, Justin Scott.
Not sure if that was a busted play or if they were intended going to the other way and the running back just forgot to take the handoff.
So a loss of two on the run by Rogers. Second and 12. Almost a blown play.
Looked like McCauley was supposed to take the handoff on that, and he just forgot.
Two wide receivers either side for Rogers. Bad snap. Rogers fumbling it momentarily, now having to roll to the far side of the field. He's going to be pushed out of bounds. This is going to be another big loss.
You can feel the momentum shifting a little bit here in this game as that Patriot defense is fired up. The sideline over here is pumped.
Patriots sideline is loving it right now. Patriots with 7 points on the board to start the half, and Parkview has been going backwards.
And one of the biggest cheerleaders on this side over here getting this team pumped up is Slade Webb over here. Like to see that.
Third down and 15 for Parkview. Ball is at their own 15-yard line. Line to gain is the 30. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Rogers. Rogers going to look to the near side of the field. He's going to have to step up. He's going to be met at the 20-yard lines by a tackler. Big play. That's number three. That's Brandon Calvert.
Nice open field tackle there by Calvert to save a first down on that. It's going to force a fourth down.
I saw Brandon out in the hallways earlier today. Main thing he was talking about, he wants to put on a show today. He heard that Ouachita Baptist was going to have some scouts in the crowd, so he said he wanted to show out. Nobody back deep to return for the Patriots on the punt. They tried to block it. This one will take a Parkview roll. Bounces just shy of the 45. It'll roll to the 35. So that's where the Patriots will start this second half.
I can understand the philosophy there of having nobody back and the fact that every snap so far for the Parkview punter has hit the ground before he's caught it.
Plus the way these low snaps have, these low punts have come from Parkview, it's been hard to read. Seems like the Patriot return men have had trouble picking up those low punts.
And right now the momentum is on the side of Marion. See if we can keep it going.
Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. First and 10, ball spotted at their own 35. Price is the running back with Kale. Kale looking down the middle of the field, now looking to the near side. It's Caden Hunt. They're going to say it was a catch.
Nice catch. Had to come back to get that one. Able to pull it in at the 49.
First and 10 for the Patriots. Ball spotted at their own 49. Three wide receivers far side of the field for Kale. Price is the running back. Near side lone receiver, DJ Johnson. They fake the handoff to Price. They're going to throw it to the far side of the field. It's intended for Caden Hunt. Batted in the air, almost intercepted by number 28. That's Trent Bennett.
That pass was just a little bit high, and had it been right on target, I saw a seam there, and I believe the receiver could have had another 15, 20 yards on that play.
Second and 10 for the Patriot offense. Ball spotted at their own 49. Three wide receivers again to the far side. Lone side near receiver, DJ Johnson. Price is the running back. Kale hands it off to Price. Price will get into the linebackers. He gets into the secondary. Price is getting to the 20. Price is going to be knocked out of bounds just shy of the 10-yard line. Big gain, Anthony Price.
And there it is. That's what we've been asking for, and we finally got it as Price was able to break one loose, takes it down to the 13-yard line.
First and 10 for the Patriots. Ball spotted at the Parkview 13. Three wide receivers far side of the field. Lone side near receiver DJ Johnson. Price remains the running back. The handoff stays with Price. Gets to the line of scrimmage. Short gain on the run. Maybe one.
Number 51, Jared Summons, nose guard, in there on that tackle.
Patriots heading towards the Little Rock Zoo, the south end zone. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Ball's on the near side hash. Kale, he's going to have to step up into the pocket. There's a ton of pressure. Intended receiver is Caden Hunt.
Wise decision that time by Kale to just throw it away. He was pressured there in the backfield.
7:09 remaining, third quarter. Parkview leads Marion 21-14, a chance to tie it up for Marion. Three wide receivers to the far side of the field. Price is the running back. DJ Johnson, the lone side near receiver. Kale looking down the middle of the field. Intended. Mari Cage. Pass is dropped by Cage. This will be fourth down.
This is going to set up a pretty tough field goal opportunity here. He's kicking from the far right hash, and we talked about how that wind is picked up out there.
Now, the flags aren't moving in the north end zone anymore, but it is still pretty windy. This will be about a 29-yard field goal attempt for Dylan Pieri. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is up. Kick is low, but the kick is good. Patriots put themselves back on the board again, trimming the Parkview lead once more. 21-17, our score in favor of Parkview. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
When you need great pizza, where do you go? Pizza Pro. When you need delicious salads, where do you go? Pizza Pro. And when you need awesome wings, where do you go? Pizza Pro. Pizza Pro is your go-to choice for pizza, salads, and wings, and soon they'll have sub sandwiches as well. Pizza Pro is open from 11 to 10 Sunday through Thursday and until 11 on Friday and Saturday nights on Highway 77 in Marion. Pizza Pro, the official pizza of the Marion Patriots.
A proud Patriot partner.
Dylan Pieri, a 29-yard field goal to trim the Parkview lead. 21-17, our score in favor of Parkview. Tyler Benton alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye on the call. Landon West directing our cameramen for tonight. McGuire Rippard, Mary Reese, and Chandler White.
Tyler, you just see a little different atmosphere here on the Marion sideline as all the players are active. They're pumped up, and momentum has shifted to our side in this second half.
10-0 run for the Patriots to start our second half. Dylan Pieri will kick things off, and we have a flag on the near side. That'll probably be a false start against the Patriots. Yep, false start on the kickoff, so Marion will kick it off from the 35.
And the way this young man's been kicking the ball, it might not make any difference. He's been kicking it out of the end zone pretty much the whole night.
He can out-kick the return man. Pretty solid. Again, while we have a second reminder, I want to see you at some Patriot volleyball games this week. Patriots will be in action on Tuesday night at Patriot Volleyball Gymnasium against the Jonesboro Golden Hurricane. And then Thursday night at Patriot Arena. Yes, Patriot Arena. Against the West Memphis Blue Devil. Should be a fun one. Patriots 4-0 in conference play. Big win over Paragon.
I've marked that one on my calendar. We do not have a tennis match, so I'll be there for volleyball action.
Pieri, a line drive kick. This one hits a lineman at about the 50. Parkview will take over at the 44.
I believe that was intentional. That was designed to do that. That's what it appeared to be from here.
So 6:58 remaining in our third quarter. Parkview a four-point lead over Marion. Sniffer back look for Parkview. Two wide receivers on the near side. Jointer is the running back with Rogers. Low snap. Ball is on the ground.
Rogers doesn't pick it up.
The ball is fumbled. It's recovered by the Patriots. D'Antonio Moore.
And there it is. It's about time that we got a break like that, and it finally happened here as in 6:52 in the third.
Big Mo totally on Marion's side right now. Momentum firmly with the Marion Patriots. A 10-0 run for Marion to start the second half. Now D'Antonio Moore coming away with a big fumble on a bad snap.
It just seemed like it took forever for somebody to get back there to follow him that ball.
Rodgers had two or three chances.
He did.
First and 10 for Marion. Ball spotted at the Parkview 35. Empty set for Kale. Three wide receivers near side of the field. Kale, designed quarterback run. He's going to keep it himself. Not too many yards on that one, but he does have a gain. Gain of about 2.5 yards. This will be second down and 8. Oh, they are going to mark it at the 32, so that's a gain of 3, second and 7. Corrects him the 32-yard line.
Nice strong run there by Kale.
Line to gain is the Parkview 25. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Marion. Price is the running back. Kale looking to the near side of the field. He's going to have to step up in the pocket, able to escape a few tacklers. He's going to be wrapped up at about the 35. He's going to be wrestled down to the 42. It'll be a loss of 3 back to third down and 10. We'll see what the Patriots can do on this drive. Then we'll throw it down to our sideline reporter, Mark Price. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Price is the running back. Moves over to Kale's right. Now Price in motion to the far side of the field. Kale looking to the near side, though. He's going to throw deep. He's got a man. It looks like DJ Johnson threw into double coverage, and Parkview made a play.
Probably not the best option on that play as he threw into double coverage, but fortunate that we didn't lose one there.
So just outside of field goal range, but Patriots not willing to punt. Looks like the offense will stay out there. Two wide receivers either side of the field. Price is the running back. Line to gain is the Parkview 25. Kale looking near side of the field. Kale looking deep. The intended receiver is Caden Hunt over the arms of Caden Hunt. That'll be a turnover on downs. First and 10 for Parkview. Ball is going to be at their own 35-yard line. Mark Price down on the sidelines. What do you got?
Coach, y'all came out of the halftime with a little fire in your belly. What do y'all talk about in the half?
Conversation was just capitalize on mistakes. We had multiple opportunities to get turnovers, and we didn't capitalize on those big plays that we should have received. And that's basically offensive side of the ball and defense side, same conversation.
Okay, Coach, get back to you. Get into this game. Thank you, Coach.
Yeah, like Mark was saying, Patriots got to be able to capitalize on the opportunities that Parkview is giving them. First and 10 for Parkview. Sniffer back look. Two wide receivers to the far side of the field. It's a high snap. It gets over the head of Rodgers. He's going to take this one, though. He does throw to the far side of the field. A receiver was in the area, so if you're a Parkview fan, you're lucky there.
Well, the center and the quarterback are not quite together on these last two plays for Parkview.
The last snap was too low, this one too high.
And fortunately for them, he was able to catch that on the hot on the bounce there rather than it fumble around there a little longer like it did on the last play.
One snap too low, one snap too high, looking for the snap Goldilocks right here.
Just snapping it just into right. The end zone.
Two wide receivers far side of the field, sniffer back look. McCauley is the sniffer back. They hand off to the running back. That's going to be number 4. It's Pre. He's met at the line of scrimmage. Short gain on the run. This will be third down and 9 for Parkview.
You know, other than the 50-yard run by Joyner for a touchdown in the second half, Marion has done a great job of controlling the run, the ground game of Parkview.
Less than 5 minutes, third quarter.
They had two. They had McCauley had 80 yards last week, and Fempster had 75 yards on the ground last week.
Flags in the north end zone are moving once again. The wind is starting to pick up here at Parkview. Three wide receivers, far side of the field. Rodgers is going to be pressured. He's going to roll to the far side of the field. He's going to throw downfield. The pass is going to be caught by number three. That's Jaden Smith. Jalen Smith able to get inside the red zone. He's going to be tackled at the 16-yard line. Big gain for Parkview.
Looked like the defender there was – he was beat on the play, and he had an opportunity, but he just mistimed.
Yeah, DeMarcus Williams, the far side corner, misread it, and it turns into a big play for Parkview. Williams, a junior cornerback. I formation for Parkview, tight end on the near side of the line. The handoff to the fullback, that's McCauley. McCauley able to get about 5 yards on the carry. Makes his way to the 11. If they mark it at the 12, so that is a gain of 5. It'll be second and 5 for Parkview.
You kind of have to put that long pass behind you and tighten up right here inside this red zone.
Back to an I formation, tight end on the near side of the line for Parkview. It's a toss. They go to Pre able to get to the 7. That would be a first down if it's at the 7. That would be first and goal, and they are going to move the chains. So first and goal for Parkview, 7 yards away from 7 points. They're giving it to Darian Bennett with the run. That would be the freshman. Bennett will remain the halfback. McCauley in at fullback. They hand it off to McCauley. McCauley has one touchdown. McCauley has two touchdowns. McCauley from 7 yards out extends the Parkview lead back to 10 right now, 27-17. An extra point could make it an 11-point game. Rivuelta will be the kicker once again for Parkview. Wind will be in his face, according to the north end zone flags. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is up. And the kick is good. 3:19 remaining in the third quarter. Parkview leads 28-17. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
27 years, one family owner, and one driving philosophy at Holly Chevrolet.
Easy, simple people to do business with. We make it as simple as possible, easy to get in and out of. The integrity that we have here at our dealership, that's what we're all about, and that's what we want to sell here at Holly Chevrolet.
We want to take care of our customers the same way we would like to be taken care of if we were doing business somewhere else.
How do you get that across to your customers?
Treat you like family.
Trust, integrity, honesty. They're why Holly Chevrolet is your wise choice in Marion, Arkansas.
Holly Chevrolet, a proud Patriot partner.
28-17, our score in favor of Parkview here just south of Markham Street in downtown Little Rock, War Memorial Stadium. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Mr. Ronnie Dye from the historic War Memorial Stadium.
That last series, just one big play kind of opened things up for them, and they were able to punch it in from 7 yards out to increase their lead to 11. See if we can answer back here with 3:19 to go in the third quarter.
Rivuelta, the kicker for Parkview. Antonio Graves, the return man on the far side. Or correction, that's Anthony Price on the far side. They kick it to Price. Price will take it at about the 22-yard line. Price makes his way past the 30. Price breaks a tackle, gets to the 40. Price gets to midfield. He's going to be knocked out of bounds at the 50-yard line. This is where the Patriots scored their first touchdown here in the second half, where they started out from is the 50. They'll get a chance to make lightning strike twice.
Nice return there by Price, the senior, as he maneuvered around and found a seam outside there. Good field position here to start this series.
First and 10 from the Patriots. Ball spotted at midfield on their side of the field, though. Three wide receivers near side of the field for the Patriots. Price is the running back with Kale. They fake the handoff to Price. This is going to be a throw to the near side. It's Caden Hunt. Hunt lowering his shoulder. The ball came out. Parkview saying they have it.
This official down here saying he is down, the one on the near side here.
Now Caden Hunt is down as well. Caden has been fighting a foot injury the last 2 weeks. Did not practice Monday through Thursday last week, and this week his foot was actually in a boot all week. So Hunt is the injured Patriot. We're going to take a break. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Welcome home at Premier Bank of Arkansas, where they exist to serve all of your financial needs. But unlike the other banks, they do it with a down-home touch. Whether your dog needs a bone at the drive-thru window, or maybe your child needs a toy while mommy and daddy handle business. Of course, who doesn't like free candy every now and then? Maybe you need a loan, or perhaps just someone to root for the Patriots with you.
Go Patriots!
Go Pats!
Go Patriots!
With locations in West Memphis and Marion, they are here for you. They are
your hometown bank. Go Patriots!
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender, a proud Patriot partner.
Caden Hunt, the injured Patriot. Patriots trailing 28-17. 3:05 remaining in our third quarter of play. Yeah, he's been battling a foot injury the last 2 weeks. His foot was actually in a boot all this week. Did not participate in practice, but out here trying his best on Friday night. So he expected a big game from him. He has one touchdown and several catches. Two wide receivers either side of the field for the Patriots. First and 10, ball is spotted at the Parkview 39-yard line. Price is the running back to Kale's right. Handoff is to Price. He's able to get into the linebackers, gets to the secondary. Gain of about 8 on the run by Price. They mark him at the 31.
Nice hole there on the left side of that offensive line to make a way for Price. See, eats up some yards there.
Second and 2 for the Patriots. 3 wide receivers near side of the field. Ball's on the far side hash. Anthony Price is the running back to Kale's right. They fake the handoff to Price. It's throw to the near side of the field. It's caught by Caleb Catt. Caught. If that is a catch, it's also a fumble. And they are going to say it is another fumble. Caleb Catt, his second fumble of the night. First and 10, Parkview. Ball spotted at the Patriot, or sorry, at their own 29-yard line.
Another one of those plays that, you know, he caught the ball. He's trying to make some. Make some yardage there and just couldn't hang on to the football.
So first and 10 for Parkview. Ball again spotted at their own 29-yard line. The third lost fumble for Marion tonight. Parkview an 11-point lead. Two wide receivers far side of the field. Tight end on the far side of the line as well. Rodgers hands it off to the running back. He'll go towards the far side of the field. Short gain, if any, on the run. They may mark him down at the 30. That would be a one-yard carry by Bennett.
Calvert, again, on the play there for the defense. Right here, you want to try to get this ball back some way. Hopefully, we can cause them to fumble it or throw an interception here.
Two wide receivers either side of the field for Rodgers. Man in motion from the near to the far side. They are going to hand it off to him. He makes his way around the corner. Gets past the 30. He's going to be pushed out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. Gain of 3. That'll set up third down and about 6.
Kind of ran into his own blocker there. Didn't have anywhere to go and kind of was forced out of bounds on that play.
Demetrius Feimster on the carry. First time we've called his name in the second half. 1:33 remaining in our third quarter. Patriots trail by 11. Three wide receivers near side of the field for Rodgers. Bennett appears to be the running back for Parkview. Rodgers going to be hit as he throws. The pass intended for number 3, that Smith, is incomplete. It'll be fourth down and 6. Parkview's going to have to give the ball back to Marion.
Nice pressure again on that play as Calvert. Calvert came in on this right side and caused their quarterback to step up, and when he did, I couldn't see who it was that came on the other side, but it was some pressure there as well that forced him to throw that.
Marion won't put anybody back. They've had some issues with the returning on the punt team, so Nobody back to receive the punt, but they are going to send a ton of pressure. The punt will bounce at about the Marion 42. It'll take a Parkview roll close to the 30-yard line. They are going to down it at the 30, and that's where Marion will set things up, first and 10. 1:18 remaining in our third quarter of play.
Still a chance in this ball game. Down 11, 1:18 to go in the third quarter. And you got the ball now on offense. You can take it down here and put it in the end zone. And plenty of time.
Patriots 70 yards away from the end zone, heading towards the Little Rock Zoo. Markham Street behind them. Three wide receivers far side of the field. That's a pistol set. Anthony Price is the running back. He picks up the fumbled snap, able to make something out of nothing, able to get 2 yards off the fumbled snap.
He'll have to come off the field now since his helmet came off.
Replacing Price will be Antonio Grays. First time we've seen Grays in at running back. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Cale. Ball spotted at the 32-yard line. Line to gain is the Marion 40. Cale looking far side.
Oh.
Overthrows the intended receiver. That's Antonio Grays. Third down and 8 for the Patriots.
It was there. He just overthrew him just a tad. It would have been a great play for Marion.
Tried to hit Grays on the wheel route. Price checks back in. Three receivers near side. Lone receiver on the far side is Doran. Price is the running back. Cale looking downfield. He's got a man open. He was double covered. Mari Cage was the intended receiver. Patriots may have to punt this one away. Now we get a whistle. There's a hurt Parkview player at the Parkview 30-yard line.
Looks like he's cramped up there in his calf muscles. That's not fun.
32 seconds remaining in our third quarter of play. Once again, we hope to see you at some Patriot volleyball games this week. Patriots will be in action on Tuesday night at Patriot Volleyball Gymnasium against the Jonesboro Golden Hurricane. Then Thursday night at Patriot Arena. You heard me right, Patriot Arena against the West Memphis Blue Devils. The first home game for the Patriots outside of the first home game for the Patriot Volleyball outside of Patriot Volleyball Gymnasium. Should be a fun one. Patriots 4-0 in conference play. Big 5-set win over the Paragould Rams yesterday in Paragould.
And Patriot Tennis has West Memphis on Monday this week coming up as well.
Very nice.
We split with them at West Memphis. The boys won and the girls. The boys won 5-2 and the girls lost 5-3.
So the girls may be looking for a little bit of revenge there.
Exactly.
Very nice. Should be a fun one. Fun week of Patriot athletics. No football action next week. Patriots played during 0 week against Blyville, so a bye week for Marion football. Boney. His punt will bounce just shy of the 40. It takes a Parkview roll to the 44, and will be downed at the Parkview 44. Mark Price down on the sideline. We go to Mark.
Fellas, we're giving this game away by fumbling the ball. We're dropping passes. Caden is playing his heart out. Has gone down with a bad ankle. Now I think it's knee. We're hoping it's not too serious. But if we keep our head in, we can win this game.
I completely agree. Just mental mistakes being the difference in this one so far. Patriots have got to clean it up. Two wide receivers far side of the field for Rodgers. They hand the ball off and go to the far side of the field. The running back is McCauley. He'll get knocked out of bounds on the Patriots side of the field, awfully close to the line to gain. A first down would be the Marion 44-yard line. They mark him out of bounds at around the 44. They're going to put it at the 46. Or correction, the line to gain is the 46. They mark it at the 47. Make sure I get my numbers right. 14 seconds remaining third quarter. So second and one for Parkview. Sniffer back look with two receivers on the near side. The running back is hit in the backfield. Short gain, if any. They're going to put him back at the 47, so no gain on the play. Great job by the Patriot defense. He's going to lose about a foot and a half.
Drew Granger was in there on the handoff. I mean, as soon as he touched the ball, he had him.
And that'll be the fourth. That'll be the end of the third quarter of play. We're fixing to start the fourth quarter. Patriots trail by 11, but still plenty of time. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Have you had a burger at the Shake Shack lately? I mean a real burger. Certified Angus beef. Did you know that Tacker Shake Shack has over 20 different burgers to choose from with lots and lots of different toppings? Try the John Wayne, maybe the mac and cheese burger, or pick your favorite toppings right off their menu. Feeling brave and really hungry? Take the Sultana Burger Challenge. Then experience one of their delicious desserts. They have homemade pies, shakes, and ice cream. And there's no doubt that their breakfast is the best around. Dine in, phone in, drive through, and delivery now available at Tacker Shake Shack, a proud Patriot partner.
A lot of history in the historic War Memorial Stadium. Patriots will attempt to make some history of their own. Parkview starts off the fourth quarter with a quarterback sneak to get a fresh set of downs. First and 10 for Parkview. Ball spotted at the Marion 45-yard line. I formation for Parkview. Handoff is to the fullback. It's McCauley. McCauley able to get past the line of scrimmage. Gain of about two on the run. Clock is on Parkview's side.
Number 54, Dylan Chappell, in on the play for the defense there.
So second down and about eight. Line to gain for Parkview is the Marion 35. Ball is at the Marion 43. I formation again. Parkview content to let the clock run as much as it can. They're going to snap it with about 6 seconds on the play clock. Handoff is to the running back. It's Jointer. I haven't seen much of Jointer here in the second half. No gain on the run.
Antonio Graves and Jaqueline Daniel were there quickly to wrap him up and bring him down.
McCauley checking out for Parkview. Marcus Hill will check back in. Clock is definitely on the side of Parkview, but they'll go back to a shotgun look. Two wide receivers, far side of the field, tied in on the line on the near side. One side near receiver, Jalen Smith. He has a big game already in this game. Handoff is to the running back. It's Jointer. Jointer, a gain of one on the run, and that is it. A flag comes in late. Flag is down at the 41-yard line. We'll see what this is about.
Justin Scott and Rogers in on that tackle.
The Patriot players are clapping. The Marion Patriot players are clapping anyway. Now the head official will come talk to Coach Houston. So whatever it was against Parkview. We have the call. Yeah, gain of one on the run by Parkview. That'll bring up fourth down and seven. Patriots will decline the penalty, not giving Parkview any extra plays.
And I believe the hold was against they were holding Scott, but I don't think he he let them let that phase him any on that play. He went ahead and was in on the tackle.
So Parkview will punt it away again. No returner for the Patriot return team. Now we have a whistle on the far side. Parkview's going to have to burn a timeout. Yeah, Parkview burning a timeout. They have two remaining. This is Patriot football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network. Patriots. 28-17, our score in favor of Parkview. Marion about to get the ball back. Big plays by the Patriot defense, trying to get their offense the ball again, down 11. No return man deep for the Patriots. Parkview's had some low punts in this one.
Officials are having a meeting there. Close to the ball, I'm not sure what's going on, but Coach Houston was talking to him during that timeout.
Looking down to the sideline, Caden Hunt with his knee wrapped in ice, walking to the sidelines in crutches, so his night is done. Another Patriot injury. Now Coach Houston wants an explanation. 9:57 remaining fourth quarter. It's fourth down and seven for Parkview. Snap is a good one. This one will take a Parkview roll. Perfectly placed. It rolls to about the 5-yard line. Parkview will down it at the 4-yard line. Mark Price is down on the sidelines. We go to Mark.
Right now it's exciting time. 9:57 left. The defense, if they can hold right here, they'll give the offense a chance for a little life. The offensive receivers have got to hold on to the ball after the catch. They're getting hit, not getting hit hard. They're letting the ball go. That's usually what happens when you have a receiver who moved away, a receiver who has a broken collarbone, a receiver who's playing with a bad foot, but they're trying to make it, and now his knee is hurt, so we got to suck it up and trust the process, and it's next man up football.
Indeed, it is next man up football for the Patriots. We'll have to see how they respond to another injury to Caden Hunt. Three wide receivers, far side of the field. Patriots with the ball at their own 5-yard line, 9:45 remaining in the contest. The handoff goes to the running back. It's Price. Price had a hand up in his face. Thought he may have grabbed the face mask there. Short gain on the run. Gain of about four. This will be second and six.
Tell you, Price is really running hard tonight. He got twisted up right there, and it didn't look good from up here where we're at, but he's okay.
Well, the original line of scrimmage was the 4, so make it second down and 5. Line to gain is the Marion 14-yard line. Handoff again goes to Price. Price gets into the linebackers. This will set up third and manageable. Third and about 2 for the Patriots. Ball spotted at the 12-yard line.
again, he got hit and fought forward two more yards on that play. Set up a third and two here.
Wide receiver injuries forcing the Patriots to run the ball more, but with trailing by 11 in the fourth quarter, might want to see the Patriots either break a long run or go back to the passing game so the clock isn't continually running. Handoff goes to Price on third down. He needs to get to the 14 to keep the drive alive. It looks like he got it. Officials timeout. They may want to take a look at this one. And we have an officials timeout for measurement. 8:23 remaining in the fourth quarter. This one will be awful close. I think it's enough for a first down, but we take a look. Just by the nose, we have a first down. So three straight runs by Anthony Price, and we get a first down.
8:23 left to go in this game, down 11. We really need to get down here and score quickly so we can have a chance here, have another possession.
First and 10 for the Patriots. Ball spotted at their own 14-yard line. Three wide receivers far side of the field for Kale. Price is the running back. Handoff goes to Price. Price able to get into the linebackers. Price is into the secondary. Price is dragging tacklers. A helmet comes off.
I believe that's going to be Price's helmet.
Yep, Price is helmetless right now. Price is laying down on his back. Helmet came off. He's helped up by his teammates. He'll have to go over to the sidelines. Big gain, Anthony Price. Antonio Graves is the running back. Anthony, a big smile on his face as he goes to the sideline. Handoff goes to Antonio Graves. Antonio to the far side. Antonio to the 40. Ooh. Oh, got tripped up. He would have had a hole there if it wasn't for the shoestring tackle by Parkview, but a big run by Antonio Graves. First and 10 Patriots, ball spotted at their own 45. I was calling for the pass. What do I know?
He had one guy to beat right there and got tripped up, and great run by Graves on that play. These big runs will open up a pass play here in just a second.
So they'll mark him at the 43-yard line. First and 10 for the Patriots. Three wide receivers near side of the field. Kale fakes the handoff. He's going to throw to the near side of the field. It's almost intercepted. Number 22 in coverage. That's Montavious Goins.
I believe that was intended for DJ Johnson. Went through his hands and kind of caught the Parkview defender off guard there.
Second and 10 for the Patriots. Ball again spotted at their own 43-yard line. Three wide receivers near side of the field. Price is the running back with Kale. They fake the handoff to Price. It's a throw down the middle of the field. It's caught by DJ Johnson. DJ trying to shed a tackle. DJ's going to lower his shoulder. He's going to get a fresh set of downs. He's going to be marked down at the Parkview 36.
Great pass there. Almost hit the official. He had to duck to get out of the way. And a nice catch and extra effort there after the catch.
Empty set for Kale. Two wide receivers far side of the field. Three on the near. Kale. We've seen a design quarterback run. This one will be a pass. It's a throw down the far side of the field. It's tipped in the air, almost intercepted. Intended receiver, that looks like number 86. That is Gabe Millen. So almost intercepted by Jalen Smith. He's been going both ways. 28-17, our score in favor of Parkview. Second and 10, ball spotted at the Parkview 36. Price is the running back. Three wide receivers on the far side. Doran, the lone wide receiver, on the near. Price now moves to the far side of the field. Comes back.
Five on the play clock.
Kale hands off to Price. Price past the line of scrimmage. Short gain of maybe two. Just over 7 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Patriots trailing by 11. Patriots will show the same look with three wide receivers to the far side of the field. Anthony Price to Kale's left. Kale looking far side. Has a man open. It's Giles. Gabe Millen. Millen hit hard at the 28-yard line. That'll be short of the first down. Line to gain is the 26-yard line. He's hit at the 28.
Great job to hang on to that ball as he bobbled it a little bit on the catch. But, boy, he was met hard by McCauley right there from that linebacker spot.
Fourth and two for the Patriot offense. Big play right here. Just over 6 minutes remaining. Three wide receivers near side of the field. Price is the running back with Kale. Patriots need to get to the 26. They fake the handoff. Pass is complete to DJ Johnson. That's going to be awfully close. It depends on the spot. They're going to put it at the 22-yard line. First and 10 for the Patriots.
Nice catch there. And anticipating the hit, which he sure got from, 22, I think.
Three wide receivers far side of the field. Pistol look with Price. Handoff is to Price. Price able to get to the line of scrimmage. He's going to be tackled before he gets to the linebackers. Gain of about two on the run. Second and eight.
If we can get this thing in under five, or around five, just a little under five, we have three timeouts left. Plenty of time left in this game.
Got to have a score and a stop. Two wide receivers either side of the field for Kale. Fake the handoff to Price. Kale looking down the middle of the field. Has a man wide open. It's DJ Johnson. Touchdown, Patriots. 5:20 remaining in the fourth quarter. The Patriots continuing to trim the lead. Now back down to five.
Nice read that time by Kale. Finding Johnson there from in the end zone.
Dylan Pierre will kick the extra point. Could have gone for a two-point conversion, trying to make it a three-point game instead. Pierre will kick the extra point. The snap is good. The hold is good. The kick is up. And the kick is good. 5:20 remaining in our fourth quarter. Patriots trim the Parkview lead back down to four. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
AMS Realty is a privately owned real estate company specializing in property management. They currently manage over 300 rental units in Crittenden County. If your rental property has become a burden, give them a call and let them tell you how they can relieve the burden. They have no upfront fees and their monthly management fee is based solely on rents collected. If they don't collect the rent, they don't get paid. Give AMS Realty a call at 739-3000.
Hello, I'm Pastor James Nicholson of First Marion. We're under
28-24, the Parkview lead. Big play, DJ Johnson, 22-yard touchdown pass from Kale. Could have gone for the two-point conversion there. I don't know what the difference between being down five and being down four is. Could have made it a three-point game.
Yeah, regardless, you're going to have to put the ball into the end zone.
So Dylan Pierre will kick things off once again. Patriots trailing by four. Ton of noise here at War Memorial. Pierre's kick is a high one. We have a whistle and the Patriots were offside again for the kickoff. While we reset, Mark Price is down on the sidelines. Mark.
Coach, he just said, want a good effort. He said, if it's going to the end zone, let it go. He just want good effort the rest of the game. So what we're trying to do now is come out respectfully, get a stop, go downfield, and take this game on back to Marion, Arkansas.
Yeah, great insight by Price. They're able to hear coach's conversation with the team. The Patriots are back down by four. 5:20 remaining in our fourth quarter. Pierre will kick things off from the 35. Remaining fourth quarter. Patriots trailing by four. Pierre's kick is a high one. This will be taken by Parkview. It'll bounce at the 20. Bad return by Parkview. Just a misread there.
I tell you what, he was very fortunate to hang on to the ball right there, because he, as soon as he started going forward, he got hit pretty good.
Biggest words right now for the Patriots, a three and out would be huge.
We have three timeouts, so we've got everything that we need to come back and win this game. It's just a matter of executing.
I formation for Parkview on first and 10. Ball spotted at their own 24. There's a toss to the outside. Big hole for the running back. It's Bennett. That is Jointer. Jointer is hit hard at around midfield at the 49. Big run by Parkview.
A very good block there on the left side to open that play up for Parkview. And Jointer took advantage of it.
So ball's going to be just short of midfield. We'll say the Parkview side of the 50.
And Parkview, they're going to take their time coming out of this huddle, and they're going to eat up as much clock as they can before they snap the ball.
I formation again. Tied in on the near side. One wide receiver on either side. McCauley is the fullback. Jointer is the halfback. McCauley takes the handoff. No gain. Justin Scott on the tackle. Justin Scott has been a space eater defensively. One of those space eater types of defensive linemen. One of my favorite, Vince Wilfork.
And if you make a stop right here, you got to look at possibly calling a timeout. Stop that clock.
Second and 10 for Parkview. They go again to the I formation. Tight end on the near side. McCauley is the fullback. Jointer is the halfback. They toss to Jointer, this time to the near side. Jointer, nice. No gain. Justin Scott again.
Justin Scott on defense right now is, he is leading the way, and he's got that defense. He has them fired up, and he's playing really well right now.
Two straight plays of no gain for Parkview. It's third down and 10 from midfield. 3:37 on the clock right now. Parkview again showing I formation. Tied in on the near side of the line. One wide receiver either side. Rogers, he's going to pass. He looks to the far side of the field. Man is not open. It's
There's
almost caught, and a flag comes out. Man in coverage was DeMarcus Williams.
Marion defenders are celebrating, but I think it's going to be called on them.
Coaches are arguing now. We have referees at about midfield. I would imagine this is pass interference against the Patriots, against Marion. So pass interference against Marion. 3:18 in the fourth quarter. A fresh set of downs. What a gift to Parkview.
Third to 10 at that point. That's a tough play.
May see the Patriots start to burn timeouts. I formation again. Or now they switch to a wildcat look. It's a wildcat look. Three wide receivers near side of the field, including a sniffer back. Rogers, the quarterback, is on the far side of the field. A man in motion from the far side to the near. The running back is going to keep it himself. That looks like Jointer. No, that's McCauley. McCauley inside. A flag comes out at around the 20-yard line, but McCauley makes his way to the 11.
I believe we're going to have a hold against Parkview back there.
So it is a hold against Parkview. It'll be from the spot of the foul, so that'll put the ball at the 28-yard line. a unique sign. First and three.
Yeah.
First and three for Parkview I formation. Flag on the near side of the field. Marion coach is having to hold Coach Carter from going out onto the field. I believe that would be a false start against Parkview. They tried to go back from that I formation to Wildcat look. It just wasn't very clean. And they're going to wave the flag. So it's still first down and three. So two straight times they've shown that I formation to Wildcat look. This is that same look again. And they go to it again. Wildcat look for Parkview.
They have
McCauley is the Wildcat quarterback. It's a low snap. He's going to be hit behind the line of scrimmage. Big play. I believe that's number
Calvert.
Seven for the Patriots. Oh, it's Brandon Calvert.
Brandon Calvert. Yes, sir. He great play there as he drove that blocker back into the runner and was able to bring him down.
Marion will burn their first timeout. 2:51 remaining fourth quarter. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Hello, I'm Pastor James Nukas at First Marion. We're under construction in our sanctuary building. We're excited about the changes that are on the horizon, but more than that, we want to help you construct your life in a way that honors God and brings blessings to you. We want to invite you to join us on November the 3rd at 10 o'clock as we dedicate our service to the ministries of Marion. Come and join us at First Marion, the church in the curve.
2:51 remaining fourth quarter. Patriots trailing by four to the Parkview Patriots. Again, we would love to see you out at Patriot Volleyball Gymnasium Tuesday night against the Jonesboro Golden Hurricanes, then Thursday night against the West Memphis Blue Devils at Patriot Arena. That's right, the basketball arena. We hope to see you there. Patriots 4-0 in conference play. Big win 5-0 over the Paragould Rams last night. Loss on the first down play. This is second and about six for Parkview. They'll show the I formation. 2:51 is where the clock is stopped. Tied in on the near side of the line. McCauley is the fullback. Halfback is Jointer. They will toss it to Jointer. Jointer to the near side. Jointer's got a hole. Jointer is into the red zone. He's going to be tackled just shy of the 10.
There's a flag back here. It's a 28. They're going to bring it back for a hold.
You like that it's pushing Parkview back. What you hate is that they're getting extra plays to run the clock. .244 remaining fourth quarter. Patriots trailing by four. Turnover or a stop would be gigantic. We've had a few bad snaps by Parkview. You would love to order one of those up right now, but with the way Parkview's been going under center here, running the ball.
Yeah, there's no way if I'm a Parkview's coach that I would risk another bad snap. I would put that quarterback under the center.
Patriots, both teams with two timeouts remaining in the game. Clock now under 2:30. Rogers is under center. A handoff to one of the wide receivers. It's McCauley. McCauley is going to be wrapped up at around the 30. McCauley makes his way close to the 25-yard line, awfully close to the sticks. This will be third down and one.
That was the play they tried to run earlier that was a busted play that McCauley didn't take the handoff.
Whistle on the near side. Marion will burn their second timeout. 2:03 remaining in the fourth quarter. 2:03 remaining fourth quarter. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
Wouldn't it be great if there was a one-stop shop for all of your automotive, hardware, lawn and garden, and farm supply needs? It just so happens that such a place exists right here in Marion. Cliff's Auto Parts. Family owned for 32 years, they can cut keys of all kinds, including transponder keys. They also create custom hydraulic hoses, and they carry a wide range of lawnmower parts. If they don't have it, they can get it. Cliff's Auto Parts, 120 Block Street in Marion.
2:03 remaining fourth quarter. Marion trailing Parkview 28-24. Tyler Bennett alongside me, Ronnie Dye here from just south of Markham Street, War Memorial Stadium. Directing tonight's broadcast, Landon West. Cameraman for tonight, McGuire Rippard, Chandler White, and Mary Reese.
Big play here, third and one.
Third and one for Parkview. I formation tight end on the far side of the line. The quarterback will keep it himself. He's going to push himself. He's going to keep on jugging. Makes his way down to the 15-yard line. Marion with one timeout left. 1:55 remaining fourth quarter. Clock will stop to move the chains. Parkview's inside the red zone. First and 10 for Parkview. Ball spotted at the 15.
Now right here, you really need a turnover of some type. If they bobble a snap or something, the clocks just continue to roll.
I formation again for Parkview. Handoff goes to the halfback. Look like Jointer. Jointer past the 10, just shy of the 9. Now that was Bennett. Whistle on the near side. That'll be a timeout. Marion will burn their last timeout. 1:15 remaining in the fourth quarter. This is Patriot Football on the Marion Patriots Athletics Network.
At Faulkner Eye Clinic, they strive to treat you the way that you want to be treated, with top quality eye care by use of technology and experience. Quality to them means being thorough and finding out how you use your vision, thus helping your efficiency. The long-term health of your eyes and vision need to be protected. That's why pictures of your retina and scans of your eyes can be important parts of protecting your vision from health issues, diabetes and high blood pressure, or vision issues like cataracts, macular degeneration, or glaucoma. Faulkner Eye Clinic. They want to help you help yourself. A proud Patriot partner. When you want hometown health care, you want Marion Minor Medical. A proud Patriot partner.
1:15 remaining fourth quarter. Parkview has the ball at the 10-yard line. Parkview going to the victory formation. They take the knee. The clock will run to under a minute with that. It'll be third down with about 6 to go. Ball's in the in between the hashes. 50 seconds left and about 17 seconds on the play clock. Parkview may attempt a field goal kick on fourth down just to secure the thing.
Finner Physical Therapy is
still
serving
7 point
game
if
opening
they do
in Marion
a field goal.
11 years later,
just under 30 seconds left. The Patriots can't stop the clock. The play clock is at 40, and that'll be the ball game.
All 5 of their locations. Other therapy services include sports injury rehab and prevention. Finner Physical Therapy.
Patriots will fall to Parkview 28-24. The teams will meet at the 50-yard line to shake hands. Patriot football off this week.
Recent injury that needs rehab, or even a past injury.
With them playing week 0 against Blyville. Next game for Patriot football will be at Hamilton Schultz Field on September 27th against the West Memphis Blue Devils.
Patriot partner.
Patriots falling to 1-2 on the season. Patriots had their opportunities. Just Parkview, just too much to overcome. Ronnie, we talk about the drop passes, the three fumbles. Patriots had their opportunities.
Well,
We talk about the missed opportunities there. Patriots had their chances, just losing a close one here to Parkview.
We did. One of the things you have to kind of do with this game is try to look for the positives. And one of the things I saw was the play by Justin Scott inside and Calvert on defense. You know, with the fumbles and things, you kind of put your defense in a bad spot. And they even though they allowed 28 points on the board, I thought the defense played better than they have all year long. So,
yep. Patriots got to get healthy. They've lost a couple key players. I think this off week's going to do them some good.
And you can't afford to lose any more receivers. We've got, you know, several of those guys hurt. And so just a tough night for Marion.
We're going to throw it down to Mark Price. Mark, our sideline reporter, has an update. Mark.
Well, fellas, the night can be explained by missed opportunities, drop balls, fumbles, missed tackles. They did a good job, but we come up again, start 1-2. Got to regroup and get ready for an open week so we can get ready for West Memphis in a couple weeks.
1-2, the Patriots will drop. Conference play starting in 2 weeks at Hamilton Schultz Stadium against the West Memphis Blue Devils. Again, Patriots with a bye week this week because they played during the 0 week against Blyville. So Patriot football will be off this week. There will be some action. I know tennis has a couple games.
Yes, Monday and Tuesday. We have West Memphis Monday and Mountain Home on Tuesday.
Very nice. Patriot volleyball, again, they'll be at Patriot Volleyball Gymnasium on Tuesday against the Jonesboro Golden Hurricane. And then Thursday night, they'll be at Patriot Arena. Yes, I'm saying it again. Patriot Arena, the basketball arena, against the West Memphis Blue Devils. Patriots 4-0 in conference play. It has been a very fun season for these girls. Ronnie, your final thoughts on our game at War Memorial?
Well, it's one of those, it's one of those you just have to put behind you and get ready for conference action with West Memphis and try to pull out a win there on the road.
Patriots falling to Parkview 28-24. For Mary Reese, Chandler White, McGuire Rippard, Ronnie Dye, and Landon West, I'm Tyler Bennett saying, go Pats.